Defending state champion Tuscola enters this morning's state championship game shorthanded. Galena makes its fourth finals appearance in the last 11 seasons. The Indians, the Pirates, next.
For the IHSA football championships. Welcome, everyone. I'm Sarah Kusak, and are you ready? If you need to get out of that Thanksgiving food coma, we have got the answer for you. In the next 2 days, we're going to be bringing you 24 hours of high school football for our first class 1A state matchup. We've got the number one seeded Galena Pirates against the number four seeded Tuscola Warriors. For your call today, let's head upstairs to Jim Spencer and Steve Mays.
All right, great matchup here in the 1A state championship games today. A couple of programs steeped in history in Class 1A. Galena here for the fourth time in the last 11 years trying to win its third championship, Steve, and Tuscola trying to make it back-to-back, and they've been steamrolling their way into the state championship game up until this week. Athletic code violations have resulted in 9 suspensions, including 3 two-way starters for the game today.
Yeah, that's very unfortunate, Jim. It's not just for the team, but it's for the school, the administrators, the players, coaches, that something like that happens. But the game's got to go on. Tuscola feels like they have enough players to fill those spots to make this a game. Like you mentioned, Galena is steeped in tradition as well. It should be a great matchup, Jim.
Now, we said their way to the state championship game, and that's what Tuscola was doing as they look at the road too, as the road that Tuscola took to get to this championship game. Look at those scores, averaging over 50 points per game. That semifinal matchup at home against Arcola, the 103rd meeting between those two great programs, also steeped in history. And you talk about steamrolling as well. Galena's doing the same sort of thing. 3 shutouts, and in that quarterfinal game against Cambridge, it was 39-0 before Cambridge scored.
Absolutely, and look at those 3 shutouts. Their defense is what can win this football game for them.
Let's look at some of the key players that are going to be involved in this game today. Back to Tuscola, and we have to start with John Wenke. Going to Michigan on a full-ride scholarship, and there you see some of his numbers. Great quarterback.
Probably one of the best quarterbacks that's ever played Class 1A football. Don't get mistaken. This guy went to a lot of camps this summer and was rated as one of the top quarterbacks in America, Jim. So he is quite a player.
And on defense, a sophomore, Jordan Nur, an active linebacker who's going to be all over the field today.
Yeah, he's one of those kids that'll make, he's made over 100 tackles for them this year, causes a lot of disruptions in the offense, and look for him to make quite a few plays for Tuscola's defense.
25 tackles for loss.
Yeah.
Now, Galena's saying, hey, you know, we got a pretty good quarterback as well. Gavin Kaiser wearing number 19, more of a threat to run and throw than to just throw like Wenke, and he's a great leader as well.
Yeah, how many quarterbacks do you see almost that have a neck roll on, Jim? He's a kid that's not afraid to run the football. He's a big kid, 6'3", 190 pounds. He'll go at it, and he won't be afraid to put the ball in the air as well.
Exactly. Then Michael Decker, we talk about active linebackers, he's going to be leading this Galena defense again that has pitched 3 shutouts here in the playoffs.
Absolutely. Look at those tackles for loss as well, 5 tackles for loss. He will blitz from that linebacking position. He's very aggressive from that position.
All right, the 1A title game coming up here in just a few moments. Let's meet the starting lineups, and for that we go to Memorial Stadium public address announcer Jeff Fritzen.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are the starting lineups for the Class 1A state championship. First, for Tuscola High School, head coach Stan Wenke. And now the starting defense for the Warriors, number 71, Kyle Bowles. Number 74, Blake Bassett. Number 61, Stephen Bosch. Number 72, Zach Bosch. Number 55, Johnny Markram. Number 15, Caleb Little. Number 73, Jordan Nur. Number 11, Zach Martin. Number 81, Shane Albert. Number 1, Travis Surma. And number 3, Clayton Meyer. And now the starting offense for Galena High School, first head coach Ed Freed. Quarterback number 19, Gavin Kaiser. Running back number 23, Michael Decker. Running back number 20, Matt Hillard. Wide receiver number 44, Logan Flack. Wide receiver number 10, Lucas Hopman. Tight end number 84, Ryan Stodden. Left tackle number 67, Patrick Redfern. Left guard number 54, Cody Johnson. Center number 55, Brian McAuliffe. Right guard number 65, Vincent Newton. And right tackle number 62, Jasper Henderson.
All right, a beautiful day here at Memorial Stadium in Champaign for this 1A state title game between Galena and Tuscola. Temperature by the end of the day will be in the lower 40s, a little crisp right now with temperatures in the lower 30s. It got down to around 20 this morning here in the Champaign area. And right now, before we talk about the keys to this game, let's go down to the field for the third member of our broadcast team. Once again, here's Sarah Kustak.
Thanks, Jim. Coach, a little shorthanded this week. It was a tough week for you. How did that affect your prep?
Didn't. Got to practice first thing Monday. A little late getting there with all the media stuff I had to do. The boys already had all the lineups fixed. They knew what boy was the best job to put in there, and they took care of it themselves.
Sounds good, Coach. Good luck today.
All right, and that leads us as we move into keys to the game here. We're going to talk about that again, that situation for Tuscola. But we're just about set and ready for the opening kickoff and the keys to the game. Brought to us by Chevrolet. See what's new at ChevyDriveChicago.com. Stay focused, number one.
Absolutely, and I think that's probably the most important one of all those three keys. Stay focused. They've had a crazy week. Let's don't forget it. Coach Stan Winke just mentioned it. A lot of media attention paid attention to the nine players that were suspended. But, hey, it's time for football.
Gavin Kaiser, the quarterback, gets a kickoff return here. He's out across the 20 on the far side and tripped up as he gets around the 35-yard line. So the quarterback on the kickoff return, Gavin Kaiser, sets Galena up with pretty good field position. That second key, obviously important right away for Tuscola. Three and outs. You do not want to let Galena establish a ball control type of offense. And there you look at the key, Steve, for Galena.
Well, exactly right. We'll get into that a little bit more on limiting the big plays for Tuscola's offense. But that bottom one playing keep away, you were just alluding to that, Jim. They have to grind the ball out. They're not a big play offense. They want to, you know, 8-10 play drives. And let's see if they can do that here in their first drive.
All right. The first play of the ball game here in the state championship game. Galena will go with a lot of different looks offensively. Decker is lined up as the tailback, and Kaiser on play action screens it out, and he's got a man across the 40, tiptoeing up the sideline and wrestled out of bounds, making the catch for Galena. Matt Hillard out of the backfield, and he's got a Galena first down on the first play of the game.
Just a minute, we talked, they're going to grind it out. They go to a little play action, get Hillard out in the flat. Gavin Kaiser could have run that football for about a 15-yard gain, did the wise thing, passed the ball, dropped it off to his running back, and picked up 20 yards on the play.
Galena, a diverse offense itself. They're averaging over 100 yards passing per game, 111, so they're not just a running team. And they have another first down play here early in the first quarter. This time it's going to be Decker, their leading rusher, and he gets minimal yardage on that play. As this Tuscola defense up to the task there. There you see the Galena starting offensive line. Jasper Henderson, a 6'5" offensive lineman.
Yeah, he's not hard to find out there on the football field, that's for sure.
And then looking at their backfield here, led by quarterback Gavin Kaiser, an All-Stater himself, and a threat to run and throw. And Decker, a solid running back at that tailback position. And Logan Flack is a speedy wide receiver as well, their leading receiver and Gavin Kaiser's favorite target in the passing game.
Yeah, Decker's one of those kids. The running back comes in with almost 900 yards rushing and about 250 yards receiving, so he's a double threat.
And we have our first penalty flag of the game. We're going to hear from referee David Mueller here.
Good ball. Delay the game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Replay the down.
All right, so that'll cost the Pirates 5. And we're looking at a second down and about 14 here for Galena.
Delay of games are something that you shouldn't see much of here in the state championship. On the north and south ends of the field, they do have the 25-second clock. Quarterbacks need to be aware of that situation.
Second and 14, under center, Kaiser. Offset eye backfield and rolling out to the far side. Kaiser had a man open deep downfield, but he elected to run it and gets back to around the original line of scrimmage. As you take a look at the defensive line for a Tuscola defense that has been dominant but plays in the shadows of Tuscola's dynamic offense.
They really do. There's their front four led by Steven Bosch, the defensive end senior.
Steve and Zach are cousins on that defensive line. There's the linebacker, as you see, Jordan Nur, 25 tackles for loss this season as a sophomore linebacker, and the D-backs for Tuscola. The Warriors trying to win back-to-back state championships, trying to become the first team in 1A to do that since Carthage back in 2000. Third and long here for the Pirates. First big play of this state championship game. Kaiser in trouble, eludes the rush. Airs it out deep down the field. The ball is going to be caught for a first down inside the 25.
Wow, what a great play by Matt Hillard. Came back to the football. Actually had about 10 steps on his defensive back. A pickup of 30 on this play. There you see a good look of Matt Hillard, the 6'1", 177-pound junior.
Hillard with two receptions on this drive to give him 8 receptions on the year. And Galena converts a big third and long, and they're down to the Tuscola 23-yard line.
Well, you can see that Galena's trying to establish them to the corners.
All right, so let's see what the Pirates can do here on first down. They'll go with a spread shotgun look here on first down. Quarterback draw, Kaiser to the outside, slips a tackle at the 25, and then Tuscola gets some help defensively. They swarm to the ball well. Looked like that play could have gone for more. Now let's take a look at our CarX X's and O's. CarX Auto Service, your neighborhood car dealer. Up front in the trenches, Tuscola's offensive line at 236. Galena up front, they run a 35 defense at 185 pounds. And then Galena's offensive line, just a little bit bigger than what Tuscola has to offer up front. But both groups, both sides of the ball, they're not about size. Both teams are about speed.
Speed and quickness.
Kaiser wants to throw.
Wow, he has all day to throw the football.
Now under pressure late, and he throws an interception. It's picked off by Travis Surma. And Tuscola forces a turnover. And the Warriors will take over on offense. That is the 36th turnover that this Tuscola defense has forced this year.
Isn't that amazing? It usually gives them great field position. We are going to get a chance to look at this one again. Gavin Kaiser, the quarterback for Galena, should probably eat this football. Good ground level shot right here. Kaiser's able to get outside, but watch the hit he's going to take right before he throws the football. And that way, Travis Surma is able to step in and make the pick.
Just the 6th interception of the season for Gavin Kaiser, and now we get to see John Winkie in this dynamic Tuscola offense. The formation that you see right now is going to be the formation you see most of the game. Shotgun spread, pass to the near side is off the hands of the intended receiver, Clayton Meyer, and it's incomplete. In talking with head coach Stan Winkie, who is the father of John Winkie, one thing he was worried about was some of the changes that had to be made in the lineup as a result of the suspensions is, can our receivers who don't have as much experience, can they catch the ball
right
in a pressure environment?
And I think part of that too, Jim, is the timing aspect of thing. A lot of their routes, Tuscola, is timing routes. Quick ins, quick outs, that type of thing.
Here's Austin Schultz out of the fullback position, and he gets solid yardage, around 5 yards on the play. Schultz, a solid running back, as you see the starting offensive line up front. Good size for Tuscola, and again, speedy and strong.
Absolutely.
Up front. Wenke, the quarterback, going to Michigan. He'll sign with the Wolverines in February. Austin Schultz, who just had that carry. Now we see a third down play here for the Warriors on their first offensive series of the game. Wenke firing. He's got a man, and it's jarred away. It looked like Shane Albert was going to be able to hold on to that one, but a jarring hit by Irvin Polito. He comes in, makes the play.
A little dinged up.
Yeah, he's
absolutely
been dinged up, and he comes in defensively and makes the play. And before the punt, looks like Tuscola is going to take a timeout. As you see the starting defensive lineup there for Galena, there you see Irvin Polito, who made that defensive play. He's actually playing with a broken bone in his foot. And right now in a scoreless tie here in the state championship game in Class 1A, we're going to step aside for this timeout. So a rarity here for Tuscola and John Wenke. He's used to throwing touchdown passes. He's not used to lining up in punt formation.
He's only punt. This is his 13th attempt all season. Real interesting seeing how he punts. He's got so much tape on his shoes, I'm not sure he can extend his toe to get his foot on the football.
And the punt downed after a 34-yard effort by Wenke, downed by Shane Albert. And Galena, good field position here. So Galena's defense does a good job. They force a three and out after the turnover.
That's one of the keys to the game. They've got to keep that ball in front of them. Did a great job. And now their offense gets it back with 7:53 left in the first quarter. Great field position once again.
Right at the 40-yard line. Bright sunshine now here at Memorial Stadium. There's a mix of clouds and sun. Not very much wind. Just a great day for a state championship game. How about four of them today?
Oh, boy.
First of four title games today. Four title games tomorrow. Delayed handoff up the middle. And back to our Car-X in the trenches. The X's and O's from Car-X. Galena up front averaging 202. And Galena, Tuscola up front averaging 173. So a slight advantage there for Galena. But again, we can't emphasize enough. It's not about, with both of these teams, it's
absolutely
not about size. It's about speed and athleticism.
Especially with that Tuscola front four, that 173 pounds. Those guys are moving, slanting, doing a lot of twisting up front just to disrupt the Galena offense.
Second down and seven. Handoff Decker. He's got room up the middle, across midfield, and he's got a first down inside of Tuscola territory.
Michael Decker again, the ball carrier.
Well, if Shane Albert doesn't make that tackle, he is off to the races for a touchdown. Tuscola put eight people in the box right there. They only had three defensive backs. All their linebackers came up the middle. Good job by Galena's offensive line picking up the blitzing linebackers.
Decker averaging over 6 yards per carry, needs 103 yards today to go over 1,000 for the season. Came in with 897 yards rushing. First down inside of Tuscola territory. Decker again hit in the backfield, slips away from the initial pursuer, and that was Jordan Nurr, who almost had his 26th tackle for loss, but Decker got away for no gain.
Well, this is what we talked about with Coach Ed Freed from Galena. This is what they wanted to do, play a little bit of ball control, a little power football, run it right at them. They're running it between the tackles right now. They feel like Tuscola probably has a little bit slight advantage, Jim, in the speed category. They're going to take it right at them.
You saw the numbers there for Mr. Decker. He celebrated his birthday with a semifinal victory over North Fulton last week, 28-0.
It's not a bad thing.
Couple of receivers on this second and 10 play for Coach Ed Freed. But it's Decker again. Bounce into the outside and mugged under after a pickup of 2 or 3 yards. And again, third and long for Galena. Galena was here playing for a state championship, if you remember, back in 2003 in the snow.
That was a great football game, great weather.
They defeated Leroy 21-20 in
double overtime
that year to become the first team in 1A to win a state championship, entering the playoffs with three losses.
If my memory is correct, I think they were a huge underdog
Leroy was undefeated and a big time favorite, and Galena got the win. Now Kaiser from the shotgun. There you see the time remaining in the opening quarter, and a middle screen pass is caught by 84 Ryan Stodden out of his tight end position, but he is going to be shy of the first down.
This is the play that Galena likes to do. They run a little drag route with their tight end. You can see Ryan Stodden coming across there, about a 5-yard drag pattern. He's got 11 receptions for 150 yards coming into this football game, so they don't throw to him very often, maybe once a game, but that's the play they like to throw to him.
So fourth down, and it looks like Coach Ed Freed is going to go here on fourth and three.
for Galena.
All right, so Galena will go. They need the 35 to keep possession from the shotgun. Kaiser. Penalty flags blow the play dead. And usually this is an offensive violation.
Absolutely, especially when that flag's thrown in the offensive backfield. Looked like somebody was a little over-anxious.
False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat fourth down.
That doesn't drive Coach Ed Freed nuts or anything, does it? You go from fourth and three to fourth and eight, and let's see if it changes his decision as to go for it or not.
Well, that brings it back closer to midfield. I think here you would probably want to punt. If any wind at all, it's a little bit at your back as you're going to see the punt unit come on for Galena.
And exactly the same way as it is for Tuscola. The quarterback is also the punter. Gavin Kaiser will be booting here.
Gavin Kaiser in punt formation.
And whenever you have your quarterback as your punter, that fake always has to be the back of the mind of the defense.
Absolutely.
So on fourth and eight, Kaiser, he loses the handle on the snap, but there's whistles, and I think delay of game was called.
Delay of game, yeah. You see double zeros up on the clock. Wow, that was almost disaster for Galena right there. Kaiser made a great job to receive the snap, but once he took off to run, I think he was going to be able to pick up the first down, Jim.
I think that he had some room to run, that's
man.
For sure. So it's going to move it 5 yards further back, and now but one thing it does do here, it does give Kaiser a little bit more room to operate, trying to pin Tuscola back.
Right. The two receiving backs for Tuscola are playing at about the 15-yard line, so they do respect the leg of Gavin Kaiser.
Kaiser averaging about 33 yards per effort this year. He's a senior All-Stater. Good snap this time. Kaiser, without much rush, had plenty of time. The ball bobbled on the return, but then gathered in by Zach Martin, and he ends up at about the 30-yard line. So this worked out pretty well for Tuscola on the punt. It was 27 yards and a 9-yard return, so you're looking at a net of just 26.
26, yeah, absolutely. Well, and they get the ball here, too. Tuscola's coming out in even another formation. They have trips out here to the right, split end to the far side, and one running back. Let's see what Stan Winkie and his Tuscola Warriors do on this offensive series.
Winkie from the shotgun again, as Steve said. Trips to the bottom of your screen. The lefty, Wenke, fires it down the far side. He's got a man, his first completion of the game, and it should be enough for a first down. And right now, let's go down to the field for Sarah Kustak.
Wenke's pass completes Travis Serna.
Galena, they're in the last 9 out of 12 season, they've had double-digit wins. The last time they've had an undefeated season was when they won the title in 97 and then followed that up with a 99 second-place finish. And now for Tuscola, since Stan Winkie has been there, they've had great success. Previous to 1990, they only had one playoff victory. Since 1990, 25 playoff victories, and they grabbed that first trophy ever for the school last year with that state title.
Thank you, Sarah. And we just saw Clayton Meyer on the receiving end of a 19-yard pass from Wenke, and for Clayton Meyer on the year, that is his 37th reception.
Yeah, he's one of the favorite targets for
Wenke.
He
leads the team in receptions.
Absolutely. Over 500 yards, 9 TDs as well. Wenke is going to look for him all day.
First down inside of Galena territory. Back-to-back completions for the Michigan-bound John Wenke. Looks back to Stan Wenke on the sidelines. It looks like they might be changing the play here.
He does give John Wenke a lot of leeway there at the quarterback position to make audibles.
Austin Schultz out of the fullback position on the carry.
Did you notice how, though, when we were talking to Stan before a game, I asked him, do you still call all the plays? And he looked me square in the eyes and said, yes, I make every offensive play call. So
not admitting that his son calls anything.
No, absolutely.
Schultz last week rushed for 174 yards and 3 touchdowns in the semifinal win against Arcola. Rush for 295 in the season finale against Argenta Orienta. A pump fake for Wenke, throwing down the sideline, and he throws it out of bounds. Travis Serma, the intended receiver. And it's third down here for the Warriors.
Well, that's what Tuscola will do to you. They'll lull you to sleep with some of the short passes they do. Travis Surma on the outside ran a little out and up route. John Winkie, nice pump fake, just threw the ball a little bit wide on that throw.
Well, Tuscola will run no huddle here, but this right now they're not in a hurry up no huddle. They want to keep Galena away from making substitutions. They're going to get to the line, make the play call at the line,
right,
and then go from there. Now, there are times that they will run a true hurry-up offense out of the no huddle, but not right now.
Well, Stan said they've been doing that of late. They've been playing a little more hurry-up when they play against bigger teams. They like to get them in the hurry-up mode.
They're going to run on third down and 7. Schultz to the outside, and he's not going to get it. Gets around the 35 before he's tripped up, about 3 yards shy of the first down, but fourth and short here for Coach Stan Winkie and crew.
Boy, that was a great block on the outside by the receiver, Clayton Meyer, who just made a big catch. He had a crackback block and really was able to free up Austin Schultz on the outside.
You talk about balance, and everybody thinks Tuscola, because of John Winkie, is just a passing team. They pass right. It all the time. But they average 182 yards rushing and 217 passing, so they're a balanced team.
Very
out of the
balanced.
Spread. When the spread's effective, it's an offense that utilizes both weapons.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So now fourth and short here, fourth and 3, and Winkie operates from the shotgun. It's Schultz up the middle. Breaks a tackle, and I don't know,
boy,
second effort got him close.
I still think he's about a yard short. They will take a look at it, but looks short from up here, Jim.
So the officials do call for the measurement. There you see some of the blue-clad Galena fans, but no measurement necessary, first down signal. No.
No,
absolutely. For a first down for Galena.
Right, correct.
It was a first down, but for the team that was on defense, there
and
we
all,
go.
For all the blue fans over there cheering. I'll tell you, you got to be impressed with Galena's defense right now.
Absolutely.
Two drives, they have played very well, and they are this type of a defense, bend but don't break. They're going to give up some yards. They know that. Talking to Ed Freed, he knows Tuscola's going to have big plays, but they have to keep them out of the end zone. So far, they've done a great job.
Kaiser, play action. Into the flat. He's got Hillard again already with his third catch. Breaks the tackle and fights out close to midfield before he's finally brought down. And there you see a good look at Mr. Hillard.
You know, Hillard, this is his third reception of the afternoon. He came into only having 6 receptions coming into this football game. But that's just great second effort, picking up about 14, 15 yards.
Pickup of 13 and a first down. Galena with first down number 4, and we've got a minute and a half for the opening quarter here at Memorial Stadium. Decker has got room to run. Decker dives to the 46, lost the football, but was already down. Pick up on the play of about 5 yards, and second and 5 for Ed Freed and crew.
You know, we've talked about a lot of the balance that Tuscola has. I'm pretty impressed with the balance that Galena has shown. You know, Kaiser, we've talked enough about him being an all-stater. He's actually an all-stater as a defensive back, but he's a great quarterback and can throw it. But I really like the way they're mixing it up and running the football this afternoon.
Because this, we talked about this Tuscola defense, it's no slouch either.
Oh, absolutely.
Most of the points that Tuscola has given up this year have been when it's sophomores and junior varsity were playing at the end of blowout games. So they've done a great job all season long. Again, Decker on the carry and leans forward across the 45. And third down upcoming. Third down and probably about 3 here for the Pirates. Galena out of the Northwest Upstate Illini Conference. Later on today, you're going to see another team from the Northwest Upstate Illini
Dakota.
Conference as Dakota will go for the 2A title against Westville in the second game.
That's pretty impressive, isn't it? You don't see that very often.
Not in the same division of that conference, but in the same conference.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep. Well, big third down play here for Galena's offense, staying with their base pro set offense.
Third and 3. This could be the final play of the quarter. Decker. Actually, that's not Decker. That's Irving Polito. Gets a carry out of the tailback position wearing number 37, and it appears, and he does have the first down.
You know, it's really amazing that he's even playing. I know you alluded to it earlier, broken bone in the foot. We thought it was just a little bit of a sprained ankle. He's got a lot of tape on that, but they feel like they have to have him on the field in order to win this football game.
And that will do it for the opening quarter here at Memorial Stadium in Champaign. We're scoreless between Tuscola and Galena. Second quarter coming up after this timeout. take a look at Galena and Tuscola. Some information about the two towns. Very comparable in terms of size. Tuscola about 4,900. Galena up in northwest Illinois about 4,000 from Douglas and Joe Davies counties. And there you see Tuscola out of the Oka Valley Blue. And they're playing against much bigger schools this year than they were last year. And we'll talk about
right.
that.
Two beautiful areas to visit in the state of Illinois. No doubt about that, Jim.
First down. And Kaiser out of the pocket on play action. Fires the ball. He's got a man. And the pass caught inside the 30. And there's a Logan Flack making the catch. Flack sliding and making his 31st catch of the year, leading receiver for the Pirates. That's first down number 6 for Galena. One of our keys to the game for Galena was keep away. Time of possession in the first quarter, 9:13 for Galena, 2:47 for Tuscola.
That's right. See, we know what we're talking about. We just got lucky on one of them right there.
But so far,
no,
so
they've
good.
Done a great job.
Yes, they have.
Keeping the football away from Tuscola's very potent offense.
Inside the 30. Delayed handoff. Polito trying to bounce it to the outside. Penalty flag comes in. Polito breaks a tackle, and he's upended at about the 24-yard line. Nice tackle by Clayton Meyer.
We're going to get a hold here on the inside, I believe, by the offensive lineman. You can always tell which one it is, but it's the one that has his hands up in the air saying, me? But looks like he got a piece of the jersey, and you're going to hear it here.
Take a look at the Galena sidelines. Galena has moved the football effectively, but yet to dent the scoreboard here. And penalties have hurt them a little bit.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat the down.
You officially hear the holding penalty call on the Pirates. And that'll be the fourth penalty of the game on Galena.
Yeah.
No penalties yet on Tuscola.
Well, and they've had great field position, but they sure have been taking themselves out of that with some silly mistakes here early in this football game.
Their first drive ended on a turnover after they got close to the Tuscola 20-yard line. And now that penalty takes them all the way back to the 42-yard line. Remember, in high school football, you mark a holding penalty from the spot of the infraction, not the line of scrimmage. So that actually costs Galena 11 yards of field position there on a 10-yard penalty. Kaiser from the shotgun, pump fakes, rolling out, and now stops and fires, and he's got a man. It is caught by Ryan Stodden again. He breaks a couple of tackles up the sideline, and he's close to a first down.
Wow, great pass by Gavin Kaiser. I thought he was going to go vertically there. He had a wide open receiver running a wheel route down the sideline. But Kaiser, I don't know if we'll see it from the top of the screen. Your inside route's going to run a wheel route. He's behind the defensive secondary. Kaiser couldn't see him. He was able to find Ryan Stodden, the big tight end, and look at him run with the football. He's running people over, trying to get to that first down.
Stodden, 6'2", 180-pounder with his second reception of the game, that one for 17 yards, and that was a first and 21 play. Here's a handoff to Polito, hit at the line of scrimmage, and he's going to be mugged under by Tuscola, and I believe that was Jordan Nurr in on the tackle.
And that's no surprise. Comes into this football game with 52 solos and 70 assists for tackles. And that kid is one aggressive player. Saw him before the game, and he was really amped playing this football game.
Total yards so far, 124 for Galena, 42 for Tuscola. Third down play here.
Little offset backfield. You see that fullback.
Kaiser wants to throw, gets it off, and it's caught by Flack, and he is going to have enough for a first down for Galena. Boy, Kaiser continues to throw the ball well.
They found a little something that they feel like they can get it out in the flats. I don't feel like they think they can run past the Tuscola defensive back. Kaiser 6 of 7 here in this football game.
Actually, after that completion, it's going to improve one better. 7 for 8 is what Kaiser is passing so far after that first down pass and catch from Kaiser to Flack.
It's a little easier when you're throwing out to the flat there. They're not throwing much vertically right now. Tuscola giving them the short routes.
Early second quarter here at Memorial Stadium. Here's a handoff to Decker back in there at the tailback position, and not much on the run there for the senior. Michael's older brother, Brandon Decker, was a star performer for Galena last year, has since graduated, so it's a family affair for Galena. Lots of tradition there, and you, Coach Ed Freed, you see him there a lot of players with brothers who played on championship teams and cousins. And
we had just, to ask him about a lot of that before the game, and he goes, I think they're related, but yeah, they do. There's a lot of family on both of these squads, actually.
10th play of the drive for Galena. Play action again. Kaiser in trouble. Chased down by Bassett. Kaiser gets away and steps out of bounds on the far side. Nobody open downfield, and Kaiser, there you see him there, able to step out of bounds and not lose any yardage.
Yeah, you see him talking to Coach Ed Freed, and he said, hey, they just made a good defensive play. They made an adjustment. They're covering the flats a little bit. Kaiser didn't have anywhere to throw the football, but he did a nice job and not force anything, and that's what Ed Freed's worried about with his quarterback. Let's don't force it down the field. Take what they give it. Hey, we can go back. We got 3rd and 11 here. Hey, we've got great field position. Let's see if we can knock it in on the next play.
Gavin Kaiser, the quarterback of this football team in the state championship game. When Galena won the title back in 1997, Casey Kaiser was the quarterback of that team. They're not related at all. Spell it exactly the same way. Live in Galena, and they're not related.
Right. Going to have a timeout here on the field.
8:23 to go, second quarter, 3rd and 11 after this timeout, and we're going to step aside. We're back to Memorial Stadium in just a moment. There you see all 32 teams who qualified for Class A. Now we've eliminated all the first-round losers, second-round losers, quarterfinal losers, down to the final four. And now here we are, the final two, Tuscola.
That is a great graphic.
That's pretty cool.
That is pretty cool stuff there.
It's our virtual bracket.
I love that.
Tuscola not far, about 20 minutes from Champaign, right down right to 45. And interesting 20-minute trip for Tuscola earlier today.
Oh, a little bus problem this morning.
3rd and 11 from the shotgun. Kaiser pump fakes, now throws it back over the middle, and it's incomplete, intended for Staden again. And before this fourth down play, let's go down to the field for Sarah Kustak.
Jim, these Galena players making waves on the football field, and also did so last year in the spring during track season. Quarterback Gavin Kaiser, wide receiver Logan Flack, and Brandon Decker, the older brother of Michael Decker, along with the injured Spencer Duplessis, made up Galena's 400 and 800 meter relay teams that took 4th and 6th place respectively at the state track meet. So these guys got some speed here too.
No doubt about it, a team built with speed, but right now they're going to try a field goal attempt of about 30 yards, and it is going to be short and no good.
Looked like it was online, Jim, just a little bit short. No wind to speak of, just a little bit of a miss hit, but pretty accurate.
Irving Polito, who had kicked 4 field goals this year, comes up short there. And before Tuscola takes over, we're going to step aside once again. We're back to Memorial Stadium in just a moment. So Tuscola takes over after the missed field goal at the 20-yard line. Tuscola's high-powered offense so far has been limited to 2 first downs and 42 yards. They have run a total of 9 plays. Galena has run 22.
That's right. That's what happens when you don't have the football.
So Wenke rolling near sideline. Fires it deep. He's got a man open. It's Clayton Meyer.
Wow,
he's got it
throw.
In stride. Tiptoeing down the sidelines. Finally wrestled out of bounds by Adam Kaiser. But a big play and a first down for Tuscola. 53-yard pickup.
Well, there's just one example right there of the arm of John Wenke. I think he's been a little bit over-anxious on some of the short balls he's thrown today. He's got a chance. Stan said, let's air one out. And there you see the stats on Clayton Meyer, who just made a huge catch and gave Tuscola great field position here at the 25-yard line.
Well, Tuscola had 42 yards until that play, and they pick up 53 on one long bomb from the left arm of John Wenke. Wenke looks to the sideline and gets the signal from his dad and head coach Stan Wenke.
You know, it looks like a hurry-up offense, but it really isn't. I mean, they want to line up quickly, but they take their time and call the audible at the line of scrimmage.
Into the end zone, tipped away and incomplete. And that's Gavin Kaiser, who is a two-way starter. The quarterback and also a defensive back makes a great play there to prevent a touchdown.
Well, absolutely right. Good ground view here of the play by Gavin Kaiser. He was an all-state defensive back, and that is proof right there. Surma was open there for a second. I think if he gets to the outside, Jim, he's wide open for a touchdown. He broke it back into the post, and Kaiser was able to make the play.
John Wenke on the year, over 2,700 yards passing. Look at 32 touchdowns and three interceptions.
Absolutely. You know what I like the best, though? He's 171 for 259. That is incredible.
And he's going to run. Wenke, a big guy, 224 pounds at 6'5", bulls his way forward and picks up a first down.
You know, he's not afraid to run the football. Hasn't run it a lot, lot fewer times this year, only 21 times for around 200 yards. But here you see the counter fake, and Wenke takes this one. It's one that they don't really respect, and they don't think Winky's going to run the ball. He's a tough runner when he gets it in between the tackles.
Well, how often is arguably the best player here at Memorial Stadium on Friday and Saturday in the state championship games? How many times is arguably the best player here in 1A?
We've done this for a long time, and I don't think I can ever talk and say that that's happened before, but I would put John Wenke up with any player in the state of Illinois this year.
And a timeout for Tuscola here with 7:34 to play in the second quarter as they're in the red zone for the first time in the game, trying to cash in here and take the lead. As there you see the offensive huddle with head coach Stan Wenke. And a win today would give Stan Wenke 150 victories at Tuscola.
Absolutely. Only loss this year was to Maroa Forsyth back in week 7, 35-28. They were in that game with a very powerful Maroa Forsyth team.
And as we look at the upcoming schedule, that last game of the day at 7 o'clock, for some reason, your last name, what is Mays, right? And then the coach at Bloomington Central Catholic, his last name is Mays, right?
That's
is there some
right.
connection there?
There's a little bit of a connection. We're really looking forward to that game. But, you know, I'm really looking forward to the next couple games before that even. There's some really good matchups. You know, when I looked at all these games, there's some really contrasting styles. You've got a passing team against a running team. You know, you've got these great players against those great players. A lot of all-staters we're going to see today. I think in those four games and those three games and the game we're seeing here, there's some great matchups.
Bottom line, park yourself on your couch and just stay there with us until 10 o'clock tonight.
Absolutely. That's right. That's what we want to see.
It's going to be a great day of football and a great day here at Champaign. There you look into the eyes of John Wenke, and he sees Galena's defense, and he's going to toss it to Schultz. He's got the 10. He's got the 5 and wrestled out of bounds on the far side, and it's going to bring up a third down play for Tuscola.
Well, that was a great, unique offense they ran right there. Double tight end set for Tuscola. You're going to see both tight ends here from ground level. Austin Schultz is going to get on the outside. Great block by Blake Bassett, the big senior tackle, 6'2", 230 on the outside.
Kaiser got him to go out of bounds. Now it's third down. Correction, the scoreboard was wrong in the previous play. It's second and 2, and Tuscola can get a first down inside the 1. Operating right now at about the 3-yard line. Wenke fakes and keeps, and he's going to be stacked up and brought down.
Well, they went back to their little counter misdirection play, the play two plays ago that Wenke was able to pick up that big first down. Galena stays at home, and we haven't talked enough about Galena's linebackers. Look at them come up and make a very tough play on a big big player in John Wenke.
So now it's a third and short for a first down, and a third down and 2 for a touchdown. 2 yards for a touchdown, 1 yard for a first down here for the Warriors. There you see the score and the time remaining in the second quarter of this 1A state championship game. Wenke on the sneak, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown.
Great.
John Wenke takes his 6'5" frame and falls forward in the end zone for the first touchdown of this championship game.
Yeah, he went behind his big offensive center, Joel Hilgendorf, right there, 6'1", 2.25". They just wedged blocked this, were able to get Wenke in the end zone.
And Clayton Meyer will come on for the conversion kick, and he's been busy with all the points that Galena has scored this year. This will be his 84th conversion attempt. He's converted on 71.
I went back and looked at that, and I said he's completed 71 PATs this year. That's amazing.
And he's got this one good, and Galena now trailing Tuscola 7-0 as Tuscola marches 80 yards for a touchdown, and to start this drive started on the long pass for from Wenke to Meyer.
Now here's a touchdown right there. We talked about Hilgendorf, the center, number 52. Look at that wedge blocking on the inside. Look at the power and strength and drive of that offensive line. A little help from Blake Bassett, number 74. Winky's able to get the nose of the football over the goal line.
So this Tuscola offense averaging 46 points a game on the year on the board for the first time after a six-play, 80-yard drive, and it took them just a minute 38. They are the football version of the fast break.
Yes, they are. Well, and they came into this game, and we alluded to it earlier, Jim, with a little bit of a chip on their shoulder. Their bus broke down on the way here. They're only 30, 40 minutes away, but halfway here, the darn bus broke down, and they had to wait 10 or 15, 20 minutes for the other bus. Stan Winke was getting quite a kick out of it, but, you know, sometimes you can turn those things into some good luck as well, and they had a nice drive there, go up 7-0 here with 6:39 left in the second quarter.
So now the Galena offense will come back in the field. And, you know, you talked about the bus breaking down. Tuscola thought they had a great plan because with the, all the renovation taking place at Memorial Stadium, Tuscola was going to have to dress at the baseball field. But
right.
They said, we're going to dress at home and then just bus here. And then the bus breaks down and, you know, the best laid plans of mice and
sometimes
men.
Sometimes don't work. Yeah, right.
Here's Kaiser on the kickoff return. Straight up the middle, room to run.
Oh, boy.
He's got the 40. It's a foot race.
He's
up
gone.
The far sideline. Kaiser is going to take it the distance. It is a 93-yard kickoff return for a touchdown for Gavin Kaiser. No flags on the play, and Galena a point away from tying this baby up.
I mean, how much can you talk about these two quarterbacks that we have on this field? They're the two best athletes on the field, and Kaiser, Galena's all Mr. Everything, and you see a great picture of him right there. Takes the kickoff and goes the distance, 93 yards. What a great run and great blocking by the front five.
Talk about a fast break.
Wow.
Galena right back at it. Now Irving Polito will come on for the conversion kick. And Polito, a solid kicker as well. He's 42 for 46 on conversion kicks. And you'll get a great look at the kick right there. And we're tied at 7. That is the longest kickoff return in the history of Class 1A football, Gavin Kaiser. Actually, that is the longest kickoff return in the history of championship football.
Boy, look at the blocking up front, though. The front five really gotten stuck with their man, and then Kaiser just uses that speed that he has, and he's gone. He literally was untouched. And, boy, that gets Galena right back into the football game. Here's a great view from it, a little aerial view right here. Watch this hole just open up. Kaiser just busts through there, uses that speed, and once he gets out in the open, I'm not sure that Tuscola has a player that can run with Gavin Kaiser.
The previous long kickoff return in 1A was by Ryan Becker from Hardin-Calhoun back in 1993 in a game against Sterling Newman. The previous longest kickoff return in any game was 92 yards by Rich Skiles in Class 3A. He's from Rock Ridge against Bishop Mack back in 1987. So a record breaker across the board for Gavin Kaiser.
That kind of woke up the crowd a little bit, too. We were a little quiet here in the stadium. We got huge crowds on both sides. That one kind of woke it up, and we got a 7-all game now.
The kickoff from Skyler Gebhardt is a short one, bounces, and then it's picked up at about the 20-yard line. Travis Surma on the return, and he's got solid. Actually, that's not Travis Surma. It was number 11 and not number 1. My apologies. That was Zach Martin, a return of 16 yards. And Tuscola has the ball right back.
Back
with 6:20
to go. Absolutely.
Well, it took a while for these teams to score, but then back-to-back. Wenke with the sneak, and then Kaiser from long distance.
Well, you knew that Tuscola was going to be able to move the football and score points. You just were a little concerned if Galena was going to be able to do the same, but maybe that kickoff will get their offense kick-started a little bit as Galena's changing up their coverage a little bit here, going to a cover two deep safeties to keep those receivers in front of them.
Screen into the flat, pass caught by Shane Albert, and Albert gets about 3 yards on the play.
That's
go ahead, Steve.
One of the things that we were talking about with Stan Winke, Jim, before the game, and you know, the typical question you have to ask him is, what has John improved on from this last year to this year? And he looked at me kind of with a surprised look, and he said, you know, not a whole lot other than he's gotten stronger. So that just tells me that he felt like he was dialed in even last year with their program and their system.
Wenke fires, and a laser of a pass intended for Surma. Surma dived just inside of Galena territory but came up empty. So it brings up third down and 7 here for the Warriors. Surma, a 6'2", 185-pound senior, great athlete, and made a diving attempt there, but just couldn't come up with it.
Surma's one of those game-breaking players that Tuscola has. A lot of speed there. Wenke really likes to look for Travis Surma.
Tuscola 1 of 3 on third down so far. Their average to go on third down is 5 yards. This is 3rd and 7. Wenke, plenty of time. Now he's under pressure, and he throws low to Clayton Meyer, and the ball short-hopped him incomplete. Adam Kaiser was there, and Adam and Gavin, no relation.
No relation, right. That's a throw you won't see John Wenke make very often. A little short hop there to Clayton Meyer. Didn't step up quite on that one, but good push by Galena's front four. And when we were talking to Ed Freed, the coach of Galena, I said, what can you do to get to John Wenke? He said, well, we got to mix it up. We got to blitz. We got to drop into zone coverage, man coverage. That particular play, they blitzed, and they were able to get close to John Wenke.
You could probably count the number of times that Wenke has been sacked this year on one hand.
Right.
Now Gavin Kaiser will try to return a punt for a touchdown. He lets this one roll, but a penalty flag, and we might have roughing the kicker here. Wenke got hit on the punt attempt, and let's get the call from the officiating crew again, led by David Mueller.
Roughing the kicker on the defense.
Well, you see the Galena coaching staff, they're not very happy with that one. They thought the Galena player was blocked into John Wenke, but the officials have made the call, and that is going to stand.
To check the distance here.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker on the defense.
That makes it automatic.
15-yard penalty, first down.
Even in high school, there is a difference between running into the kicker and roughing
right.
the kicker, and this was called roughing the kicker, and it gives Tuscola a first down via the penalty. And it moves the Warriors inside of Galena territory to the 47-yard line.
Once again, Stan Wenke, you see all the players looking to the sideline. I'm a little confused. Last year I thought they wore wristbands with some of the plays on there. This year they don't have the wristbands going on with everybody flipping the cards and all that. Stan's just yelling them from the sideline and with a series of codes.
Trips to the top of your screen. Wenke is going to screen it out into the flat, and he's got Schultz, his fullback, spinning forward inside the 45 and upended around the 43-yard line. Short gain on the play.
Little bubble screen to Austin Schultz. You're going to see Travis Surma go down and block on the inside linebacker. And Austin Schultz, they just try and get him out here. One-on-one matchup. They like their chances if they can do that. And that time, Schultz was able to pick up a couple yards.
On second down, Wenke again to the air. Eludes the rush. He got hit as he threw, and he threw it up for grabs. And Kaiser had it right in his belly. And he couldn't come up with it. Adam Kaiser's going to kick himself later on. That would have been Wenke's 4th pick of the year, but it goes for naught. So it brings up third down, and Wenke took a pretty good shot there as he unloaded that ball downfield.
He really did, and Kaiser took a huge hit after he missed the interception. And this is a ball, I think, that John Wenke thought his receiver was going deep. You can see right there, and boy, Kaiser needs to make that interception. Those are the plays right there that you have to make to win a state championship.
There you see Wenke looking to the sideline, getting the play call. His lineman already at the line of scrimmage, and now third down at about 8 from the 44. Wenke looks far sideline, and he throws a pick. It's intercepted, making the pick for Galena. Nathan Bingham out of his defensive end position. Sometimes he'll roll back and play as a linebacker as well there, and that's what Bingham does. He gets the pick, and Wenke's 4th interception of the entire year.
Zach Martin is the intended receiver. You're going to see John Wenke able to step up on this one. Zach Martin just didn't get across the middle as Galena steps in and makes the interceptions, and now they will have great field position here at the 38-yard line. 4:40 left to go, first half.
So Galena starts this drive at its own 38-yard line. Hand off Decker, room off the left side. He's got a first down and more into Tuscola territory before he's wrestled down around the 46-yard line. 16-yard gain for number 23, and another first down for the Pirates. They're eighth of the game.
Boy, Decker's starting to find some seams, isn't he? Gets a great block from number 10, Lucas Hopman, down the field. You're seeing right there, that's a tough block for a wide receiver. You got to literally latch onto that guy for 4 or 5 seconds. Good job by Lucas Hopman.
Decker has picked up 40 yards on the ground in this game, adding to that 897 that you saw that he had coming in. He gets a break, and Hillard from the tailback position this time, and he spins his way forward for about three.
Galena's changed up their offense a little bit right
They'll
now.
They'll do that. They'll change formations a lot. I mean, they're gonna run eye. They'll run some double wing, and they'll go double tight. I mean, they'll do a lot of different things.
That particular play, they decided to go to double tight. I think it balances the defensive line a little bit. Tuscola was starting to blitz their backers a little bit. Ed Freed makes a change, say, hey, we're going to go double tight. Not on this play. They're going to spread out and go back to their traditional pro-eye formation.
Kaiser will duck under center here with 3:35 to go before halftime. Polito to the 41. Wrestled under there. Travis Surma was one of the warriors around the football there.
Good block by number 67, Patrick Redfern, right there. Left tackle from his left tackle position. I'll tell you, I'm impressed with Galena's offensive line. They really get after it, say low. Tuscola's front four that we talked about is not the easiest group to block. Not big, but we've mentioned it a couple times. Very quick, very active.
Third and four here for the Pirates. Line of scrimmage, the Tuscola 41. Inside of 3 minutes for the second quarter. Kaiser rolling out under pressure, and he gets rid of the ball. It's up for grabs and nearly caught. Boy, Kaiser did a great job to just get rid of that football, and he still had some mustard on it too.
Wow, I'm amazed at how much mustard he's able. He's literally hogtied here from the back side, and this is one that you go as a coach, you're screaming, no. You never throw that football back across the grain like that. Kaiser is a senior, wouldn't expect that out of him. He's just trying to make a play.
Well, look who had him. It was John Winkie.
Matt Hillard almost made that catch too downfield. That would have been enough for the first.
So fourth down, and Kaiser on the field to punt here for Galena. Tuscola has one timeout left with 2:47 to go before halftime. And it's a fake.
Oh, wow, he feels like.
And he's got the first down. Gavin Kaiser continues to electrify here in the state championship game. He is to the 31, and it's a first down on the fake punt for Galena.
You know, I'm sure that's something they saw on film, Jim.
So Kaiser on the run, on the fake punt, and Galena keeps the football. Remember one of our keys being keep away? That plays into it right there. Decker back in there, tailback, and he's got the carry up the middle, and he's mugged under.
Yeah, I wanted to finish a thought a little bit about that on that. Probably something they saw on film as Kaiser rolled into this punt formation. They feel like they can use his speed. They had two receivers go down, block, crack back block. Kaiser was just able to get outside and pick up plenty for the first down.
Adam Kaiser getting the play from head coach Ed Freed. Freed was the co-coach along with legendary Chuck Cordy back in 2003 when the Pirates were here and won the state championship. We talked about that electrifying win over Leroy, 21-20 in double overtime. Kaiser from the shotgun here on second and eight. He fires down the field. Hillard is open, breaks a tackle, and he's gone. Touchdown for Galena, a 28-yard pass play, and Galena has a 13-7 lead on Tuscola with 91 seconds to go in the second quarter. Boy, Hillard had caught 8 passes all season long.
Right.
He's caught 4 now in the state championship
game. Been amazing, and that was a great play fake by Gavin Kaiser. You're going to see a little pump fake as well if we get to the replay.
Irving Polito to attempt the extra point.
So now Polito will come on for the conversion kick. And it's 14-7, Pirates on top. So the fake punt leads to a touchdown. Kaiser now making a play for a touchdown in the passing game.
See the little pump fake right there by Kaiser. Great grab by Matt Hillard, and he's able to fight off a bad angle that the defensive back from Tuscola took and get into the end zone.
So there you see the score and the time remaining in this Class of 1A state championship game. And the IHSA thanks Jim's Mobile Offices for their support. Jim's is Illinois' only locally owned and operated mobile office supplier. Located in beautiful Marion, Illinois, repeat customers are Jim's best clientele.
We got ourselves a ball game here.
And you know what? 1:31 to go. One timeout for Tuscola. That's plenty of time for John Wenke.
Doesn't matter. That's right.
And Tuscola won the toss before the game, and they deferred.
Deferred.
So their choice in the second half, and they're going to get the football. So an opportunity, if Tuscola can do something here, an opportunity for maybe a two-for-one type of possession for them to have the ball at the end of the half and then get the ball
get
to start
right
the third quarter.
Right.
Short kick. Bounces to the 20. And a gang tackle at about the 32 or 33-yard line. That was Austin Schultz on the return for the Warriors.
Well, we'll definitely see the hurry-up offense here by the Tuscola Warriors
hurry
now.
Hurry up, I mean, it's the normal offense for Tuscola.
Absolutely.
Tuscola last year defeated Aledo in the state championship game, 35-20, and Wenke in that game, as a junior, set a 1A playoff record, passing for 384 yards in that contest. And it's going to be Schultz, not much. They tried to run, and boy, this swarming Galena defense.
Boy, I think that was Ryan Stodden from his backside linebacker position, number 84, coming blitzing through that offensive line and making a huge play. Now if you're Tuscola with 1:05 left, you've got to play hurry-up football.
Well, Wenke coming into the game had completed 66% of his passes. Wenke so far in the first half, 5 of 13 for 91 yards. And 53 of those 91 came on one play.
Absolutely. That's right. That's right.
Second and 9 from the shotgun. Wenke is going to fire it deep down the field, looking for Clayton Meyer. The ball tipped away and incomplete.
Wow, that was almost another interception. I think that was Gavin Kaiser, wasn't it, coming over from his free safety
position?
It was
Gavin and Adam there
right
on coverage.
Well, you're going to see the two best players on the field trying to make a play here. John Wenke throwing the football. And look at Kaiser. Gavin Kaiser, 19, go out, lay out for that football. I think 8 times out of 10, he's going to make that catch.
Athletes making plays, and now it's 3rd and 9 for Tuscola with 42 seconds to go in the first half. We've almost played 24 minutes, and Tuscola has only had the ball just over 6 of those 24 minutes here in this title game. You see Wenke as he looks in. His team facing 3rd and 9 from its own 34. And a delay of game is going to be called. You know, I think there's a problem if you're moving
dead
towards
ball,
the north.
Delay of game, offense, 5-yard penalty, repeat the down.
If you're a quarterback looking to the north, that play clock is way up
it
on the top of the stands there. It's not within eye view. If you're going the other way, that play clock is kind of within eye view and much easier to see. When we've had delay of games in this game, it has been teams going that direction.
Absolutely.
So now a timeout on the field.
Well, you see Stan Wenke out there. I don't think he's very happy with the play he had called right there. John was making an audible. He's pointing out a few things to his offensive lineman right there. They haven't really been giving John Wenke very good protection here in the last couple series.
Now from Galena's standpoint, you feel if you force an incomplete pass here, Galena still has 2 timeouts left. You might have an opportunity to do something, especially if maybe you block a punt, get a good punt return. And Galena would have some time if they make a stop here on 3rd down.
Well, I think you'd have to use the timeout. And if they do run the play, I can imagine that Ed Freed will call timeout, force the punt, because you are going to have Gavin Kaiser, your best player, returning the punt. And that's what you want.
So if you're Stan Wenke, do you run the ball and make them call a timeout, or do you throw it and risk the incomplete?
Well,
decisions coaches have to make.
Yes, they do.
A concern, Stan Wenke on the sidelines. 3rd and 14 for his son, John. Under pressure, steps up. Wenke's going to keep it, And he's not going to get the first down, and he goes out of bounds to stop the clock. And wow, a Frosta sideline. Scary looking play there as he had to hurdle the bench over there. And obviously he looks okay, but woo.
Wow, you don't like to see a kid doing that, especially a kid of the caliber of John Winkie going flying over the bench. I can't really tell if they are trying to throw the ball down the field or if this is just a really a quarterback draw setup. But I'm surprised that John didn't actually try to stay in bounds and go down and keep that clock running. Went out of bounds, stopped the clock. 35 seconds left to go here in the second quarter. Tuscola is going to be forced to punt.
So Wenke to punt again. And the kick is away, line drive. It's going to go past Kaiser, and he lets it roll inside the 20. Good effort there by Wenke, and it pins Galena way back as that ball continues to roll on the field turf inside the 10. That's a 55-yard punt for John Winkie, and that's exactly what Tuscola needed.
That's a really good punt under that pressure and that circumstance right there.
I would be surprised right now if Ed Freed doesn't elect to take a knee right here. Tuscola out of timeouts, and I think if you're Galena, you took a chance hoping for good field position. You didn't get it. Now you go into the locker room up 14-7.
Get to the half up one score. I think they have to be very pleased with how this first half has gone if you're a Galena fan. They have controlled the ball and played keep away, one of our key stats that we talked about before the game.
Well, the kickoff return for a punch for a touchdown and then the fake punt.
That's right.
Have been huge in the first half for Galena. So Galena does take a knee.
Penalty flag on the field.
There's Ed Freed wondering what's going on. As the referees will sort things out here, and we'll find out.
Well, everybody's pointing fingers at each other right now. We'll get the call. Might have been an illegal substitution call.
Illegal participation on the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Illegal participation, the technical term for too many men in the field. And that's 15 yards. And now maybe things change from a strategy standpoint here for Coach Ed Freed and company.
I still think he's happy with that 14-7 lead at half. Take one more knee, get to halftime, and keep the momentum rolling.
There you have it, the first half in the books. And an exciting first half here between Galena and Tuscola. Tuscola trying to win back-to-back state championships, and Galena trying to win its third in the last 11 years. It's 14-7 in favor of the Pirates. So again, we talked about the big plays with Galena and the 93-yard kickoff return for Gavin Kaiser. Then Kaiser makes another big play with the fake punt. And let's go down to the field right now. Sarah Kustak is standing by.
Thanks, Jim. Coach, you get that second touchdown off of the fake punt. How'd you size up that situation to make the call?
Well, it was fourth down. It wasn't too long to go, and we felt like we had good field position, and you know we need to take some chances. And our offense is moving the ball well, but we haven't a couple drives early. We didn't finish it with a score. So we felt like we got to be the aggressive team and take a chance there. And luckily, it worked out.
Tuscola averages 46 points a game. How are you keeping this potent offense under check?
Well, right now our defense is doing a good job, but they've been doing a good job all year. And but we know we have two more quarters, and against an offense like this, you can't relax because they're going to go after us. But we're confident. Our defense is playing super all year, and we got to come up with the biggest half of the season right now.
Absolutely, Coach. Good luck the second half. Thank you, guys. Back up to you.
All right, there you see the score at halftime of the 1A state championship game. The Pirates on top of the Warriors. 14-7. We'll have more halftime activities from Memorial Stadium in Champaign coming right up.
Third
13-0 Galena Pirates holding that 14-7 halftime lead here in the Class 1A state championship ball game. Tuscola looking to go back-to-back. They've got their work cut out for them. And welcome back to Memorial Stadium, everybody. I'm Dave Bernhardt, joined again this year by Jason Kirby from Sherrard High School, Scott Hamilton from Unity High School. And, you know, guys, we take a look at this first half, and, you know, Tuscola comes in with all the raves, all the numbers, but, boy, has Galena just locked it down here.
They've done a wonderful job of making sure that they aren't letting any big plays happen. And with that being said, the one long pass play was a big deal and drove and helped to drive down for a score. But outside of that, keeping everyone in front of them.
Yeah, and don't forget the quarterback, the all-everything guy for Galena with the big kickoff return to answer for Galena. What a big play in the game and a big answer to get them going again.
You know, and that's why I wanted to say, you know, John Winkie was all the name coming into this and deservedly so, but, boy, Gavin Kaiser has just taken control of this game.
Everything that he's done, both offensively and defensively, being back there, making sure no big plays happen, playing back there in the defensive secondary was huge.
And how many times do you see a quarterback returning kickoffs?
Not very often, and he had a huge kickoff return to open the game. And we were like, whoa, he's returning kicks, and then he broke up a ball deep playing safety and had a game-saving tackle on a sideline run that kept him out of the end zone. So it's a battle of two quarterbacks, but you know, there's a lot of other people that are playing awfully well. The linebackers for Galena are doing a great job stepping up and stuffing the run, and I think that's the key to stopping Tuscola is being able to defend the run and forcing John into just being a thrower.
You know, we will get those yardage numbers in a little bit, but when you force Winkie into being a thrower, I mean, we see the damage he can do. I mean, we've seen it for a couple of years here. He's headed to University of Michigan. But you take a look at what Galena's done defensively. You kept saying we were sitting there in the first half. They've just kept everything in front of them. Explain what you mean, Jason.
Well, the defensive backs are playing a lot of man coverage. And as Coach said as we were talking, they're mixing up their coverages very well to give some different looks, which is causing some trouble for Wink, I think. But in doing that, those defensive backs, as they're playing man, are keeping things in front of them, and they're allowing the shorter passes to be caught and not letting any long runs take place after that, but then stopping the deep throws from being made as their free safeties are coming over.
There you go. Well, I'll tell you what, before we get more comments, we'll take a break. We come back. A lot more coming up from Memorial Stadium. It's the 1A state championship game, and it's a 7-point lead for the Galena Pirates. Welcome back to Memorial Stadium. It is the first of eight state championship ball games here in the next couple of days. 24 hours of football coverage right here in the IHSA TV network. And, you know, we talked about how Galena has really done an outstanding job here at 14-7, and that's despite surviving some penalties. They had some penalties near midfield that stopped a drive, in effect, when they were going to go for it on fourth and short, and that was early, and then a roughing the punter penalty, and yet they've been able to maintain.
Yeah, you know, they've survived. They've had good field position despite those penalties, though, and I think that's put Tuscola down in the hole for most of their drives to begin with. You know, you look back at key plays throughout the course of the half, and how about the fake punt that Kaiser had? Another big play by the quarterback, and, you know, what a tremendous game, what a tremendous half. And the thing I look forward to in the second half, I think both teams will open up a little bit more. I think the first quarter was played fairly conservative here in this Friday morning, and I would look for both offenses to open up a little bit more and have a little more fireworks.
You know, it's funny because we were talking in the first quarter, we were thinking about, you know, what are we going to talk about at the half, because not much was going on. But is that really true of the first game of the day, where it just takes either team a little while to get going?
Well, I don't know if that's necessarily the case. I definitely think that Galena is doing a great job offensively of keeping the football and trying to keep Tuscola's quick strike offense off the field. And Tuscola's worked with a short field virtually the whole year. Them, as you said, having a long field, and then Galena actually having the football so much, using their counters, doing a lot of things, misdirection to try and keep the ball for long sustained drives, is working out very well for them.
Well, we've had three touchdowns on the board. Let's take a look at that scoring summary here in the first half. The scoring summary brought to you by Sports Authority. It's Sports Authority, dedicated to the dedicated. There it is. First touchdown in this game came on a 2-yard run by John Winkie, and that came at the 6:39 mark of the second quarter for a 7-0 Tuscola lead. Then Gavin Kaiser took all of 14 seconds to take the ensuing kickoff 93 yards for a Class 1A playoff record to tie this game at 7, and then following a Nathan Bingham interception at the 38-yard line with 4:40 left, and then following a fake punt by Kaiser at 2:38, at the 1:31 mark, it was Matt Hillard, 20-yard touchdown reception, and that's where we stand right now, 14-7, Galena on top of the Tuscola Warriors. And if you're Tuscola, of course, we've heard the adversity they've had this week. But now you've got to regroup in the locker room. And what's happening in the locker room right now with the young men that they have standing underneath Stan Wincke?
Well, I think coach is probably talking to them. It's not a position they've been in very much this year, especially in the playoffs. They've had good success early on and been able to go into a second half where they've been able to kind of play control and not blow it. Now they're going to have to come out and attack in the second half. And I know that Stan loves to run that offense. And I think it's, now's the time for him to open it up and father and son to have one great second half. And I'd sure look for John and Coach Wincke to have a good second half here and put up some numbers.
Yeah, definitely.
Any other thoughts, Jason, before we go to break?
I think Galena's got to continue to do the same thing in the second half. Control the football, take the short passes, and move the football on first downs.
All right, we'll take a break. We come back. There's more coming up your way right here at Memorial Stadium. Galena 14, Tuscola 7, 1A championship game at the half. Big crowd building here in Champaign. The first of four games coming up in just a little bit. It'll be Dakota and Westville, a couple of undefeated teams going at it in Class 2A. But first of all, we have to get ourselves set for a second half in Class 1A. Let's take a look at our halftime highlights brought to you by Honda. Honda featuring the all-new 268 horsepower Accord V6. And John Wincke got things started following a long pass. He takes it in from 2 yards out. The extra point kick is good. And the Warriors lead this one 7-0 midway through the second quarter. But then on the ensuing kickoff, Gavin Kaiser back at the 9-yard line coming right at you. And there's a hole right there. And goodbye, the quarterback / defensive back and now kick returner, a Class 1A state playoff record 91-yard touchdown run. And that ties this ball game at 7-7. But the Tuscola Warriors would come right back, driving down the field, taking advantage of a roughing the punter penalty. John Wincke, for only the fourth time this year, is going to throw an interception. That's a big deal right there, especially when Nathan Bingham will pick that one off. And that sets it up for a score from Gavin Kaiser, doing it all, taking it to the right side, looking down that right side. Here will come Matt Hillard. A little spin move there, and 20 yards later, he takes it in, and that takes us to our halftime score of 14-7. And back with you, Dave Earnhardt, Jason Kirby, along with Scott Hamilton. And first half stats coming in, and obviously the score is the most important thing, but what have you noticed on the Galena side?
On the Galena side, I've noticed that Kaiser's 8-for-11 passing the ball. That's incredible because the clock's not stopping on the incompletions. Once again, long drive, sustained, clock moving the entire time, and he's their leading rusher with 42 yards as well.
Well, there you go. You talk about passing and rushing, it's one man, and throwing the kickoff return.
Yes.
Guys
had
an all-state performance in the first half. On the other side, Tuscola, Scott.
Yeah, I think that, stat-wise, John Wincke, 5-for-14 with an interception is very uncharacteristic of him. But I think the thing that steps out here for me is Austin Schultz with 22 yards rushing. I think if Tuscola is going to get back into it here, they're going to have to get some more yards on the ground and be able to mix it up and force Galena to put some people in the box.
Well, let's hear what Stan Wincke has to say. Let's go down to the field and Sarah Kustak.
Thanks, Dave. Coach, your team used to putting up big numbers. What's been the biggest challenge for your offense so far?
Well, just being consistent. We've got a lot of holes, and we've got guys filling them, and I don't fault their effort at all. We're playing hard, and the kids are trying hard, but a lot of them are never used to being starters, and we're just not very consistent. Hopefully, playing two halves at this kind of game, this is a tough one to start in, but hopefully it gets better in the second half, and we'll be okay if we can get some consistency.
Galena scores coming off of the work of special teams. What happened on that kickoff?
Well, unfortunately, that's where most of our guys are missing. But, you don't get a choice of what ones you got to play. So, we'll make some adjustments, and we did at halftime. But we got to do a little better job on special teams. That's obvious that's where we got hurt at.
Sounds good, Coach. Good luck this second half. Dave?
Thank you very much, Sarah. And we've got a good second half coming up, as we will have 8 games today. It doesn't get much closer at the half. 14-7, Galena on top of Tuscola. Second half coming up next.
That thing pops up.
14-7, Galena on top of Tuscola as we're getting ready for the start of the second half of this Class 1A state championship game. And one of our keys to the game, you look at Galena, we talked about limiting big plays for Galena. We talked about making Tuscola work on longer fields. And we talked about Galena playing keep away. And it's worked to a T so far for Galena.
They did all of that, and I think the big one is keep away. They were able to control the ball, take up a lot of time on the clock. But I also thought that another key that we mentioned was limiting big plays, and they did exactly that. They gave up the one long pass, 52 yards. But other than that, Jim, I thought they controlled the clock and controlled the play on the football field.
16 minutes and 37 seconds. That's how long Galena had the football in the first 24 minutes of action. And it wasn't just a running game. It was Gavin Kaiser mixing things up. Great balanced offense, right. Great game plan for Ed Fried and company.
You know, sometimes time of possession can be kind of an overlooked stat, or you pay too much attention to it. But when you're not giving up big plays on the other side on defense, it is an important stat that they are taking time off that clock. Ed Fried wants to get this ball game into the fourth quarter and be close. And right now, they're better than close. They're 7 points ahead.
And Tuscola obviously wants to keep the football and improve that time of possession factor. But when you're 1 of 6 on third down and your average distance to go on third down is just 5 yards, I think that tells me your timing as an offense is off just a little bit, and it's showing on the field.
Absolutely. No doubt about it. Good look at our upcoming schedule here the rest of the afternoon and into the evening, as we do have 3 more football games after our game this morning.
Westville and Dakota. Westville and Dakota both undefeated. Westville in the title game last year lost to Moroa Forsyth. Dakota trying to win for the second time in the last 3 years. Columbia and Plano. Columbia never played in the title game before. Plano trying to win it for the second consecutive year. Great matchup there. That Columbia team runs the spread just like Tuscola does, and Plano runs the wing tee.
Yeah, it'll be what a contrast in styles that will be.
And then in the finale tonight at 7 o'clock, I heard Driscoll's pretty good.
I mean, you know, I think they are.
They're an okay
team.
They're
back again, I hear. You know, 6-time defending state champion. And, man, watching them on film this week, they're pretty darn good. So that'll be quite a matchup at 7 p.m. as Bloomington Central Catholic goes against Driscoll Catholic.
And Stan Wenke down on the sidelines trying to instruct his troops as they're going to get the football first. As we start the second half, and I think this first drive for Tuscola is big, not
necessarily.
It's critical because I think that their confidence has taken a hit, and I think they want to get that back. I mean, obviously they want to get that back. They need to get that back and quickly, because this Galena team has seized control of this contest.
Well, they're out of sync a little bit,
yep.
And that's to be expected from the players they lost. But Coach Stan Wenke thought that they could get that back and, you know, get through the pregame jitters and all that, but they just seem a little bit out of sync. Let's see if they can get that back going here in the second half.
And Schultz on the return, the opening kickoff return of the second half off the kickoff from Skylar Gebhardt, and Tuscola will take over. Once again, with relatively poor field position for them as they start inside of their own 30-yard line. So Tuscola again averaging 52 points per game in the postseason. Held to 7 points.
That's
here
phenomenal.
In the first half
that
against
really
Galena.
Is. And you got to remember, a lot of that was done in about 3 quarters because their starters literally didn't play much of the fourth quarter in their 4 previous playoff games.
So John Wenke, who was just 5 of 14 and threw an interception in the first half, hands off to Alston Schultz. Schultz with first down yardage as he bursts out across the 40. And it's a first down for Tuscola, their 7th of the game. And Schultz in the first half was held to just 22 yards rushing.
Yeah, he only carried the ball 6 times. I think, obviously, that play is an indication. Coach Dan Wenke, we got to give the ball to Schultz. He's one of our playmakers. John's struggling a little bit today. Let's give it to Austin Schultz and see if he can pick up the slack.
He picked up 13 there. And it gives the Warriors a first down. Wenke fires for the home run, and he overshoots Travis Surma down the left sideline. And it'll bring up a second down call.
Adam Kaiser again on the coverage right there. Boy, he has really played a great game. He's got a tough position today. He's pretty much shadowing Surma the entire game and has done a nice job so far here in the first half.
Tuscola, we talked about them being a fast break kind of offense, and you look back to the quarterfinal game against Mount Olive. Mount Olive controlled the time of possession in that game, but Tuscola scored 49 points on 36 plays. That's just incredible.
That is.
Here's a running play again, and it's close to first down yardage. Schultz with the carry out of the fullback position, And let's see if he's 2 for 2 here on second down, on second half carries. And he is. 2 carries and 2 first downs for number 41.
Tuscola's bringing a man in motion right now, using him as a trap on that inside guard for against Galena. Galena's starting to bring some more backers right now. Those backers are playing pretty close up to the line of scrimmage. Watch for Tuscola to break a long run.
Wanky wants to throw this time, airs it out to the sideline. He's got a man inside the 40 and wrestled down right there is Travis Surma. And he'll be about 5 yards shy of the first down.
You know, I know it's only a 5 yard gain, but how many high school quarterbacks can make that throw right there? He's sitting in the pocket. Surma's his about a second or third read. He throws a rope about 25 yards for only a 5 yard gain.
Surma with the second catch for him in the game. And for Surma, he now has 34 receptions on the year. Tuscola has 5 receivers with 25 or more receptions on the year. There are some high school teams that don't have 25 receptions. Here's a pass to the far sideline. Clayton Meyer goes up in the air and makes the catch, and that should be good enough for another Tuscola first down.
Well, there's a throw right there that Tuscola was having a little problem with hanging on to in the first half. That ball that's just not right to your chest. You got to go up and get it. That's a nice catch. Keep the flag sticks moving.
So now Tuscola will get to the line of scrimmage here. Their modified hurry-up offense, early moments.
Man coverage again by Geneva, or Galena, I'm sorry. In the secondary, you got a free safety playing in the middle of the field all by himself, little man-free coverage.
Austin Schultz again, and he runs into Ryan Stodden and then is dropped, but a solid run for Schultz. As Tuscola trying to maintain some balance here offensively, and Schultz and Wenke have combined to start a nice drive here. Tuscola started this drive back inside of its own 30, and now they have penetrated inside of the Galena 30. It's going to be second down and about 4.
Galena staying with that base 4-man front defense, 2 middle linebackers. Let's see if they come on this play, try to get to John Wenke. Both backers drop into defensive coverage.
Play action, Wenke fires down the field, the ball tipped away. It was Adam Kaiser again making a big defensive play.
I'll tell you, that's the best matchup on the field right there, Surma against Kaiser. And eventually one of them is going to make a big play. This is a frozen rope once again by Wenke, right on the money. But Kaiser just, you know, that's good offense and good defense. I mean, there's nothing you can do about that. It's a tough assignment that Kaiser has out there on the corner. You know, you got to remember, if he misses a play, it's a touchdown. I mean, if he makes a bad play defensively, Tuscola will score a touchdown.
Tuscola 1 of 6 on third down. They're 1 for 7. Schultz goes nowhere. As the Galena defense swarming, and again, Ryan Stodden making another defensive play. Stodden had 3 tackles in the first half. Michael Decker actually led the Galena defense in the first half with 6 tackles. Michael Decker, our key defensive player of the game for the Pirates.
Got a little help from number 64, Vincent Newton, right there on a stunt up front. Defensive lineman stunted right into that play. They finally figured out that little motion. They're going to run a trap. Newton stunted right into it, was able to help stack up that play.
John Wenke looking to his dad and coach for this 4th down call. 4th and 7 for Tuscola. Play action. Wenke for the home run. The ball up in the air, and it is intercepted. Was no, out of bounds. Gavin Kaiser made the catch, but he was ruled out of bounds. But Galena's going to get the ball anyway. It was 4th down.
Well, there's a reason that these officials officiate in this game. The official is right on top of this play to make the call. And watch Kaiser. He makes a great play, but watch his knees hit first. He's out of bounds. That's just a great play call by the official.
He was bobbling the ball. So he right didn't have control as his knee hit out of bounds.
Wow. He did eventually make the interception, but his first contact was with the white stripe, and he was out of bounds.
So Tuscola turned away again, as Tuscola now 0 for 2 on 4th down. Tuscola now a combined 1 for 9 on 3rd and 4th down combined. Gavin Kaiser, who had a huge first half, is under center, and he wants to throw again. He throws down the field. He's got Logan Flack, and he had it and lost it. Flack went up and nearly made a great play, but he comes up empty. Kaiser was 8 of 11 in the first half for 123.
Matt Bailey on the defense right there, number seven, did a nice job. Flack actually was bringing that ball down for the reception, but Bailey was there to knock it away.
We talked about Flack and Gavin Kaiser. Sarah talked about them being part of the relay teams for Galena, the 400 and 800 meter relay teams that advanced to the state meet and earned medals last year. We'll talk about another member of that team here in just a second after this play. And it's going to be a handoff to one of the members of the brother of one of the members of that team. Brandon Decker was on that team. The ball carrier there was Michael Decker, but Spencer Duplessis was the fourth member of that team. And Spencer was injured early in the season for Galena. Spencer, arguably Galena's best player.
No.
A two-year all-conference player as a sophomore and a junior. He suffered a bad foot injury, broke a bone in his foot. And after a couple of weeks, they thought he was going to be out 3 or 4 weeks, but they found out he actually had a broken bone and ligament damage, and they had to do extensive surgery on the foot, and it might cost
tough
him his
injury.
Track season as well.
Right.
He's a senior. Kaiser looking to throw. Hit as he throws. He got rid of it, but the pass ruled incomplete. Boy, Kaiser went down hard, and you see him grimacing down there on the Memorial Stadium turf. Boy, a jarring blow here.
That might have been Jordan Nerr from his backside linebacking position, as you see the huge hit that Kaiser takes. Good protection up front, but you just can't protect. You can't block everybody. Backside backer coming in and really puts a hit on Kaiser. That was almost a fumble, Jim.
Very, very close. And now Kaiser has to stay in the field and punt here. Fourth and six.
That's tough to punt when you've just had the wind knocked out of you on a sack like that. Let's see if Kaiser can get a good one off here. Oh, wow.
Got a very good one off. And it's going to be Travis Surma at the 25. Surma slips a tackle at the 35 and then escorted out of bounds. And Ben Plemer making the tackle. 40-yard punt, 16-yard return. It'll be first down for Tuscola after this timeout. All right, there you see our Walgreens photo. Do the right thing. Walgreens and the IHSA are teaming up all over the state to promote good sportsmanship. So now Tuscola's going to take over at its own 41-yard line, trailing 14-7 here in the state championship game. Wanky fires, and it's dropped right into the arms of Clayton Meyer, and he couldn't hold on.
That's the play right there that we talked to Stan Wanky about a lot in the bubble before this game. He was very concerned about being able to hang on to the football. I know we've mentioned it a few times, but, you know, with the suspensions, they lost about 1,700 yards in receiving in those players. He was going to have somebody else step up. They got to start making the catches. That ball's right between your numbers right there. I know Wanky puts a little zip on it, but that's a timing route, and that ball was right where it should have been.
Now second and 10 after the incomplete pass. Hand off again to Austin Schultz, and he gets to the 45. This will bring up another third down here for the Warriors. Third down and about six.
You know, the neat thing about Galena's defense, their front four don't make a whole lot of tackles, but they, you know, they clog things up, and they do a great job of keeping those offensive linemen off of their linebackers. Nathan Bingham, Chad Crawford, Ben Wasman, Jasper Henderson, and Cody Johnson. I mean, those guys do a great job, and they allow their linebackers to make plays, and that's what's happening here this morning.
Tuscola tries again on third down. They're 1 for 7 on third down. The average yards to go on those third downs is 6.2. And penalty flags on the play and delay of game once again. Again, the quarterback has a hard time seeing that play clock.
Dead ball, delay of game, offense.
You know, with that glare and that shadow up there, I don't think they can see that.
We've heard from David Mueller all game long, and here is the officiating crew from around the Neponset, Cambridge area. David Mueller, John Pickering, David Hullen, Al Corwin, and Kenneth Wilcoxon, a veteran crew of officials working this 1A title game today.
What a great job they've done, too. They've had some really tough plays, calls to make. We just saw one about four plays ago. The official made the great call, and that's the quality of official we see in the state championship games.
Wenke fires, great catch, first down, or very close to it. When he made the catch, he had the distance but got pushed back. Surma goes up, makes the grab, and on the mark, he will have first down yardage here for the Warriors.
Well, Tuscola's going to come back and get into this football game. This is the guy that's going to have to make plays for him right there, Travis Surma. He's the fastest guy, fastest receiver they have. Look for John Wenke to start looking for Travis Surma a little bit more.
All right, so a big conversion there. So now they're 2 of 8, and that was third and long. And Wenke and Surma hook up for a big one. That was an important catch right there for Surma, and Tuscola stays in the field. Wenke again. Fires down the middle. He's got a man open, and it's off his hands and incomplete. And that intended receiver was Zach Martin. He's a senior.
Boy, I love the play call right there by Tuscola. They went all verticals. They ran five receivers vertically and really put a lot of pressure on Galena. And John just overshot the receiver right there. I think we're going to go to timeout here, Jim.
6:01 to go in the quarter and a timeout called by Tuscola. And the team will huddle around head coach Stan Wenke. And during this timeout, we're going to go down to the field and we're going to hear from Sarah Kustak.
Thanks, Jim. Well, you guys talked about the spread offense that Tuscola runs, and Coach Stan Wenke actually picked it up from Rich Rodriguez, who's now at West Virginia, but Coach Wenke picked it up in the 90s to cater to his quarterback, Dusty Burke, that was a two-time All-American. And one of the greatest assets of his son, Wenke, is that he's got the smarts, and he understands it, and he gets it, and it's going to make for a great transition for him as he heads into college and off to Michigan next year.
I thought that a class 1A quarterback again going to Michigan. it's hard to believe, but you know, the advantage that Mr. Wenke has, that John Wenke has in regards to being noticed by a school like Michigan is the fact that he's 6'5" and he's 225 pounds.
Right.
He's got D1 quarterback type numbers in terms of his size. And if you have those kind of numbers, then they're going to look at your tape and then they're going to look at your numbers. And lo and behold, he's now at Michigan. He was offered by 16 different Division I schools.
Right. Everyone that really came to see him and thought they had a chance, they offered him a scholarship. So everybody that saw him liked him, and I see why.
He's 8 for 22 here today. Handoff Austin Schultz, and Schultz doing a good job here in the second half. At halftime, Schultz had just 22 yards rushing, and now he's pushing 60 yards for the game. So he's had a solid third quarter on the ground. So now another third down coming up here. Third and about 7 for the Warriors. They just converted a third and 11 moments ago.
Boy, I bet this is more than third and longs than Tuscola's had all season. It seems like every time we look up, it's 3rd and 7, 3rd and 8.
Wenke looking, flushed out. He's going to run, breaks a tackle and dives forward. And maybe got a yard on the play, but it brings up 4th down.
You know, Galena's doing a great job clogging the middle. We've talked about it a couple times. They want to get Tuscola running to the sidelines. They feel like they have that speed advantage. Right there is a perfect indication of what they wanted to do.
Ryan Stodden once again in on the play for Galena. And it looks like Galena is going to, I'm sorry, it looks like Tuscola is going to go here on 4th down. 4th and 5 from the 42. Wenke. And the ball deflected away, flying in. Cody Johnson got a paw on it, knocked it away, and Galena takes over on downs.
Yeah, Cody Johnson's one of the outside linebackers, number 54. Tough guy to throw over. He's one of those linebackers that's tall, 6'2", was able to knock it over.
We'll be back to Memorial Stadium for Galena on first down after this timeout. First down for quarterback Gavin Kaiser in the Pirate offense. Handoff, Hillard off the left side, spins forward to the 49. And he's dropped there, a solid run for Hillard, who caught 4 passes, including a touchdown for Galena in the first half.
I think one of the keys to the game that we haven't talked a whole lot about is force long drives. They've been forcing long drives to Tuscola. They just haven't been able to complete their drives, and that's a credit to Galena's defense. Their offense done a great job controlling the football, picking up good yardage on first down. They just did it there again, picked up 6 or 7 yards. I'll tell you, I'm very impressed with the game plan that Ed Freed and his coaching staff put together.
Decker lined up at fullback here, Hillard the tailback. And Hillard on a delay, kind of a counter Trey looking play, and he's got room to run up the left sideline. Hillard up to the races inside the 25, and finally wrestled down by Shane Albert. A huge run and a pickup of 30 yards for Matt Hillard, and he's having himself quite a state championship
game.
Well,
he really is. You can see the counter app gap action right there. Offensive line getting on their block, staying on them. Gets a nice block downfield, and once again, Matt Hillard's picking up some tough yardage. And now they're almost to the red zone, threatening one more time here with 3:52 left in the third quarter.
Clock ticking here, you see it on your screen. Galena up 7, looking for more. Kaiser, handoff, Decker breaks tackles. And it's a, I'm sorry, that was Hillard again.
It's very hard to distinguish between those two. You know, one's 20, one's 23, but they're built the same way. And we talked about it in the first half. Galena's gone back again to that double tight end formation, basing up on that defensive line and starting to push people around right now.
Well, Hillard has now rushed for a team-leading 52 yards and has also caught 86 yards worth of passes in this state championship game. Second and 4 from the Tuscola 16. Hillard again, why not? This time he stopped and it'll bring up third down.
Boy, a huge hit by Jordan Nurr, number 73, the outside linebacker.
Doesn't he fly around?
Oh my God, there's a reason he
and
has.
And he's only a sophomore.
Oh, that's amazing, 52 tackles for solos and 70 assists. But that kid is quite a football player.
Nurr actually played a lot last year as a freshman on the varsity and the state championship team, played 3 or 4 different positions, and during the offseason, he grew about 4 inches, put on about 25 yeah. pounds to get up to where he's at now. Nurr, 6'1", 198 as a sophomore. Third down, average yards to go for Galena, 5.2, they're 3 for 7. Kaiser under pressure, gets the pass off, it's caught in the flat by Hillard again, and he's down to the 1. Boy. Kaiser doing a great job throwing just in time for a 15-yard gain and a first and goal coming up for Galena.
Yeah, and he threw it over the John Winkie, a 6'5" defensive end running at you right there. That's just a great individual play by Gavin Kaiser. And once again, you see Matt Hillard. He almost snuck in the end zone right there. First and goal from about the 6-inch line.
Inside of 2 minutes, you see the numbers for Hillard coming in. Quarterback sneak, and it's a touchdown. Gavin Kaiser on the sneak into the end zone, and it's 20-7 in favor of Galena.
Well, you have two of the co-captains up there, Cody Johnson and Vincent Newton, number 65 and 54 respectively, the two offensive linemen. They're starting to push people around and take over this football game.
And now for the conversion kick, Irving Polito once again trying to make it a 14-point game. Kaiser holds it, and it's 21-7 in favor of the Pirates with 1:47 to go. A 6-play, 57-yard touchdown drive.
Here's what we were talking about. Look at that offensive push right there. You see a lot of white jerseys going backwards as Gavin Kaiser is able to get into the end zone, and he's a couple yards into the end zone on that push by that offensive front.
That drive took just over 3 minutes to commence, and the Galena defense making the big fourth down stop. The offense took over and marched right down the field, and that was Matt Hillard's drive. Hillard on the ground and made a tough catch, and then Kaiser into the end zone. Boy, Hillard has had himself a game, 47 yards rushing, 101 yards receiving for Matt Hillard on 5 grabs.
Absolutely, as Gavin Kaiser, the quarterback, is now 9 of 14, 138 yards. He's had a quality game as well. And the thing that's most important, turnovers. No turnovers. They are just hanging on to the football and playing an excellent game here in Champaign.
The kickoff from Skylar Gebhardt from Galena. From the 15. Straight up the middle, Austin Schultz out across the 45-yard line before he's finally brought down, and great field position off the 32-yard kickoff return for Austin Schultz. And Tuscola needs a spark right now. They need something to get their confidence back, something to fire them up a little bit, because they're in trouble.
Well, we saw Galena run one back. It looks like Austin Schultz found a nice little seam. Looked like he almost could take that one back. And like you said, that might be the spark that helps them here in the second half, because they have been very, very flat in the first half.
Well, Galena's starting defense has only allowed one touchdown the entire playoffs, and that was in this game to Tuscola in the first half. Galena on top 21-7 here, trying to win another state championship. Wenke in the flats, he's got a man. Pass caught near the 50-yard line by Zach Martin. And Martin a little bit slow to get up.
Boy, he took a tough hit here at the end of this play right here. Martin goes, climbs the ladder, goes up and gets this ball. Tough ball to catch, running away from the quarterback. Tough hit right there on the left shoulder.
There was a flack in there. Irving Polito trying to make a play in the ball. Late third quarter here, as you see Martin still down on the field here at Memorial Stadium. Galena on top, 21-7. Galena's offense has been a great defense against Tuscola's offense here in the game so far.
They really have.
20 minutes of time of possession for Galena so far, compared to just over 13 for Tuscola.
You know, a couple of the amazing defensive stats that I saw from Galena when we started researching for this game, they didn't give up a point in the first quarter this year. It was and they've only given up 91 total points for the entire season. And as you mentioned early in our broadcast, 22 interceptions and 19 fumble recoveries coming into this game. This is a very stingy defense. This is one of the better Class 1A defenses you're going to see.
Yeah, Galena has forced 42 turnovers.
Jeez.
Defensively this year, their turnover differential, including what's happened here today, is plus 28.
Right.
That's just amazing. And we talked about the fact that pitching shutouts, three shutouts in the playoffs
That's
so
amazing.
Far. And in the other game against Cambridge, they were up 39-0 before Cambridge scored against some of Galena's reserves. And the touchdown that Tuscola scored in the first half, the first touchdown that Galena's starting defense has allowed the entire playoff run.
That's playoff football. That's amazing. I mean, it gets tougher, folks, as you go on in the playoffs. You're playing, teams that haven't lost and teams that have scored a lot of points. They have three shutouts in the playoff. That's amazing. You don't see that very often.
They're shutting down arguably one of the most dynamic offenses in the history of Class 1A football. You look at the scores for Tuscola coming into this game in the playoffs. 60-0. 62-8, 49-27, and 48-6 as you look at Tuscola right there. The scoring averages in the playoffs. Actually, in the playoffs, they're averaging 52 points per game, outscoring their opposition in the playoffs by an average score of 52-10, and there's Galena's numbers. Again, those 3.5 points that they gave up.
Yeah, that's what you noticed out of that stat right there.
And that was after the game was out of reach.
That's amazing.
After it was already 39-0. So, and it's not, Galena, not just a huge imposing defense. It's about guys that are big enough, but very athletic, very speedy, fly to the football, and wreak havoc. And that is what they've done. They have probably applied more pressure to John Wenke in this game than he has felt all season long.
Absolutely, no doubt about it.
Now, they haven't taken him down yet, but they've been in his face. They've batted on some balls. They've made him throw passes earlier than he would have liked. I mean,
right.
They have
to his second and third reads that he doesn't like to, and then when he's throwing to his second and third read, that's not the receiver that's been in there throughout the course of the year. So the timing's mixed up a little bit, and that's what Ed Freed said they had to do. You know, that you can't just sit back and play zone against this group here. You got to do a lot of different things, and they've done it, and it's really worked right now.
Walgreens and the IHSA are promoting sportsmanship across the state, and here Jordan Nur doing the right thing. Kaiser into the end zone, and Jordan Nur helping him up after Kaiser scored the latest Galena touchdown to make it 21-7. And you never like to see the cart come onto the field to take an injured player off, but that is what is happening here. So we hope the best for Zach Martin.
But this is all a part of the safety aspect for the player. Mm-hmm. We're hoping that the player is not seriously injured. They get him and take care of him. The emergency staff and what Dave Ganaway and the IHSA has done running these state championships is incredible, and this is just part of it. We hope the best for the player, and he'll be in good hands.
We're going to see a replay of what happened here.
You know, it's a tremendous catch here, and you're going to see when he goes down, he's in kind of a very vulnerable position right there, head, neck bent back a little bit, and shoulder. And I couldn't really see if it was his knee. Looks like it's a knee to the head almost. Well, we'll let the viewer watch it right here. You do see the knee come in there late to the shoulder and neck area. So let's hope all things are okay for number 11, Zach Martin.
Martin is a senior, a two-way player in this game for Tuscola. He lines up in the slot as one of Tuscola's four wide receivers, and he also plays cornerback on defense. So Tuscola has eight two-way starters in this game today, and that's always tough. You have one injury, and it affects two positions.
Right. Absolutely.
You see some of the Galena faithful. The injury occurred on the side of the field that they are on, and they are interested and hopeful, of course, that Zach Martin from Tuscola is okay as the medical staff continues to tend to him down on the field. There's a minute 25 to go here in the third quarter of this Class 1A state championship game, and Galena undefeated, trying to complete a 14-0 run to a state championship, which would be their third in the last 11 years, and they're playing in their fourth state championship game during that span. Also had a runner-up finish in 1999. So the Pirates, a great football tradition, just like Tuscola. Galena in the playoffs for the 21st time in the last 23 years. First of four state championship games being staged at Memorial Stadium today, 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A, and we're back at you tomorrow here on the IHSA Television Network as well. Four more games tomorrow, 5A, 6A, 7A, 8A. The old post-Thanksgiving feast of football right here on the IHSA Television Network as you're getting some pictures of the renovation taking place here at Memorial Stadium. Phase one, you're looking at phase one right there here at Zupke Field and Memorial Stadium. Now you're looking back towards the press box. Phase two, I think those are the phases. That's still construction going on the press box side of the field, the west side of the field, but they did a great job on the north side, which is the new student section. And when this is all done, this
it's
is going
incredible.
To be a spectacular facility.
We've gotten a chance to walk through some of it. It's really going to be amazing, and I think the amazing part of it is going to be this press box area where you and I are at, Jim. It's pretty impressive and incredible, but when you see what's happening around the Big Ten, you know, at Ohio State and Michigan and Iowa, Purdue, you have to have this type of facility. And look what Coach Zook has been able to do with this team when you start – improving the facility, improving the players on the field. And when you do that, people want to come out and watch you. And I think this is a tremendous environment for the students and the fans to come watch a football game.
Illinois going 9-3 this year, beating Ohio State at Ohio State. Quite an impressive run for Coach Zook. And the knock on Zook is always that he is a great recruiter and maybe not much of a game coach, but made some great calls during some big games this season that allowed Illinois to win some big games this year and put themselves in position to be playing on New Year's Day this year.
Well,
quite an incredible turnaround.
Yeah, I think he surrounded himself with some great coaches. Coach Zook's one of the top coaches in America, no doubt. He has an unbelievable staff as well, from the top to bottom, and he's got a great administration he works for that allows him and gives him the tools to be successful, and they've done a great job. So here we're seeing the player coming off of the field.
Some of that do the right thing kind of attitude that the IHSA and Walgreens are promoting. You saw some of the Galena fans and all the fans applauding and as Zach Martin was helped onto the cart to take him off the field. You never want to see anything like
no,
that.
No, it's about as quiet as it can get in a football stadium right now, and rightly so.
So hopefully we can get an update on his condition, and we'll pass it along to our viewers and let them know how Zach's doing.
Great sportsmanship on the fans of Galena, Tuscola, and even the players on the field giving a hand to Zach Martin. Let's keep him in our thoughts, and hopefully things will be okay. Part of the Do the Right Thing campaign.
Brought to us by Walgreens and the IHSA. All right, back to the action. It's going to be second and six for Tuscola. 21-7. Pirates on top of the Warriors here, as Tuscola has penetrated into Galena territory. Wenke from the shotgun. Hand off Schultz, and he's dropped immediately. Gain of maybe one on the play.
Isn't it amazing? You think that play is opening up. From our view, we're sitting up pretty high here in the stadium. That play looks like it's wide open to me, but it closes so quickly. Those linebackers from Galena are so quick to the football, and they just seal up those holes. And now it's a tough situation, third and about four.
From the 48. Wanky screen pass near side Schultz. Schultz hit and dropped, making another big defensive play again. Cody Johnson, he batted that fourth down pass down earlier in here. He takes down Schultz to bring up fourth down.
Well, that's all you can ask from your defense right there, is to do assignment football. Cody had a read right there. His guy went out, led him right to the football, and made a huge play. And now on fourth down, is Stan Wenke, is the staff going to go for it?
And we'll probably find out what happens in the fourth quarter. The clock ticking down there. It's the end of the third period. It was 14-7 Galena at halftime. Now as we enter the fourth quarter, Galena on top by two touchdowns. Fourth quarter action from Memorial Stadium in Champaign coming up after this timeout. Well, if Tuscola is going to win back-to-back state championships and become the first team in Class 1A to do that since Carthage back in 2000, the Warriors are going to have to rally here in the final 12 minutes. There you see the score. And as we start the fourth quarter, it's fourth and nine.
Big play in this football game. Wow.
Wenke flushed out, and he's sacked.
Is that Cody Johnson again, 54? I think it was. That was Chad Crawford, number 64, pardon me, from his defensive tackle position, 5'10", 218, made a nice move inside. I thought by the speed there that was Cody Johnson, but it was actually Chad Crawford, number 64, making the play.
All right, so Galena's defense holds on downs again as Tuscola is now 0-for-4 on fourth down in the game.
Great field position.
They start inside of Tuscola territory. Galena with an opportunity to maybe ice this thing away. Here's Hillard again out of the tailback position. He stopped at the line of scrimmage.
Well, now if you're Tuscola, you've got to start ripping the football. If you stand up a running back, you got to start ripping. They need an interception, a turnover, something good to happen. You mentioned it early in the third quarter. There's nothing happening for Tuscola. No turnovers, no big plays. If they're going to get back in this football game, something better happen quickly.
Both teams with one turnover in the game, an interception for each quarterback. Second and 10 for Galena from the Tuscola 43. First minute of the fourth quarter. You see Logan Flack move in motion. Kaiser rolling that way. He throws it down the sideline. Pass is caught, and out of bounds is Adam Kaiser on the far sideline. Again, if you weren't tuned in the first half, Gavin and Adam, same last name, same community, spelled exactly the same way. They're not related.
No relation. And this is just playing pitch and catch right here. A little quick out route right there, Kaiser to Kaiser. And did a nice job staying in bound, keep the clock running. I like the play calling by Ed Freed. He's not going to just run it between the tackles. He's going to make Tuscola still cover the entire field.
Both quarterbacks have completed 10 passes in the game, but Kaiser is 10 for 15, Wenke 10 for 25. Kaiser has thrown for 145. Now third down. They're 4 of 8 on third down. Here's a handoff, and it is not going to be enough. Fourth and short upcoming here. Hillard on the carry again for the Pirates.
You saw wishbone formation right there, Jim, trying to sneak in between the two tackles.
And we have another
player down on the field.
Another injured warrior. As the clock stops with 9:58 to go. Galena on top by a couple of scores here, and they're going to be faced with a fourth down when we return to Memorial Stadium in Champaign after this break. Let's take a look at what happened to Stephen Bosch here.
You see him go across the number 61 right there. Knee to the arm, knee to the elbow, hands area.
Yeah, that would be painful.
That would hurt.
Fourth and short here for Galena. And it looks like they're going to go for it, and they are. Galena 1 for 1 on fourth down in this game. Gavin Kaiser. Quarterback sneak, and he didn't get much, didn't need much. It all depends on the spot here. They'll untangle the pile.
Boy, he's very close.
First down, no need for measurement. Galena keeps the football.
Nice surge right there by Brian McAuliffe, the center, number 55. He's had a nice game, as have all of these linemen for Galena.
On third and fourth down combined in this game, Galena is 6 for 11. Tuscola is 2 for 14.
Well, there's a big story in the game right there, no doubt.
Handoff. Hillard inside the 30.
Boy, he's a hard runner, isn't he, Jim? 6 foot, 175, 180 pound kid running right at you. You're starting to see some white jerseys going backwards right now, picking up big yardage on first down.
Hillard's had the big game. We talked about receiving yardage, 101 yards receiving. And now Hillard with 55 yards rushing as well, came in averaging over 8 yards per carry. Second and 4 from the 26. Inside of Tuscola territory, 9 minutes. For the final quarter. Kaiser taking his time. Handoff again, and Hillard again inside the 25, and he'll be a little bit short of the first down to bring up third and short here for the Pirates from Galena.
Gavin Kaiser, the quarterback, is taking his time. Jim, you happened to mention that. The clock is right in front of him. He can see the 25-second play clock. He's winding it down to 1 or 2 seconds before they snap the football. They feel like every second is valuable. They want to get that time off the clock, and they want to keep John Winkie and that high-powered Tuscola offense on the sideline.
Here come the Pirates. You look right into the eyes of senior quarterback Gavin Kaiser. He's had a huge game. 93-yard kickoff return for a touchdown in the first half. Handoff, Hillard, first down. He fumbled the ball loose, but Galena able to get back on top of it. Hillard came back to get it.
What a huge hit at the end of that play. He was actually 2 or 3 yards past the first down markers. Fumble's going to take it back to 2 or 3 yards short. You're going to see the play right here. Hillard up the middle. Great seam right there. Trying to see who that was. Was that Surma coming in there? Number one making the big hit. It was Travis Surma with the big hit. And now we'll have 4th and 2.
Yeah, that was Surma who knocked the ball loose. And Hillard might have got a little bit of an assist from the official there. Deflected that ball right into the spot for him to pounce on top of it. So here comes Galena again. Another fourth down play. As we approach the 7-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Gavin Kaiser. Play action. On the run. He's going to turn the corner, get the first down, and then he's pushed out of bounds.
Well, that's just pure speed right there. He's faster than anybody on the football field. Bootleg, and all they're trying to do is tell Gavin Kaiser, find a seam, get into the opening. You see the play action. Look at the linebackers. Safeties have to respect that, Jim. And then Kaiser just uses that speed getting outside. He did have an open receiver in the end zone, but did the thing he should do as a senior quarterback and senior captain. Kept the ball, picked the first down up, keep that clock running. Now we're down below 7 minutes.
Right now, Galena wants, I mean, they don't need any more points right now.
Right.
They want that clock to get to triple zeros as fast as possible. Kaiser's had a big game, has thrown for 145, and he's rushed for 22 and had that long kickoff return. Also that big fake punt. Here's a handoff.
Oh,
Hillard
touchdown.
Cuts back, five, and touchdown. Hillard does it again. Matt Hillard on the run this time, takes it into the end zone, and it's 27-7 in favor of Tuscola, in favor of Galena.
But it's just a great job by the offensive line, piling it up in the middle, little zone play, little iso play up the middle, and Matt Hillard heads to the outside. That wasn't a design play to go outside, but that's where it was. Got a great back block from Logan Flack, number 44 on the outside. Score the touchdown.
Irving Polito makes it 28-7 with the conversion kick. 6:37 left to play here in the fourth quarter. And it's a 3-touchdown lead for the Pirates. We'll be back to Memorial Stadium in just a moment. Here's Matt Hillard continuing his stellar performance here in the 1A state championship game. Nothing up the middle, finds the outside, finds the end zone, a 9-play, 43-yard touchdown drive, taking 5 minutes and 10 seconds, and we go down to the field for Sarah Kustak. All right, so we'll touch base with Sarah a little bit later on. We thank Sarah for being here on loan to us in the IHSA Television Network from some place called ESPN. So it's a pleasure to have her back here on the sidelines for all of these state final broadcasts. Here's a squib kick, and Clayton Meyer on the return for the Warriors, and he's dropped shy of the 35-yard line. So does John Wenke and his Tuscola offense, do they have a rally in them? We're going to take a look at the Army defensive play of the game here.
Well, this was on the fourth down play that Tuscola had a drive going. And once again, look at those linebackers for Galena making huge stop after huge stop in this football game.
Yeah, Ryan Stodden was the first linebacker to get there on that one to make that play. So now Tuscola down 3 scores, 2 timeouts left for the Warriors, and they trail 28-7. They start from their own 33-yard line. Wanky throwing to the far side. Pass caught. Travis Surma breaks the tackle. Surma has got a first down as he goes out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Pickup of 13 for Travis Surma.
Good look at the strength of the arm. John Wanky once again throwing a little 10-yard out right now. That ball's on a rope. Surma, his favorite target, able to pick up extra yardage. That's what you like to see. Kid making a play, catch after first contact, make a little extra yardage, get out of bounds if you can. Got to stop that clock. You see who came up and put the lick on there at the end is Gavin Kaiser, your quarterback and free safety, put the lick on at the end of that play.
Wanky to Austin Schultz out of the backfield, makes the catch into Galena territory to the 49-yard line, pickup of 5. You know, Tuscola, they're a big play offense. They thrive on big plays. They've had one big play, the long pass in the first half. That has been it. And this dominant Galena defense has dictated what has happened here in this game. I think at some point we're going to see Coach Stan Wanky employ that hurry-up spread offense that we talked about. Certainly they need to hurry up now, down by 3 scores. Wanky for the home run, down the sideline, ball up in the air, and it's intercepted. It's intercepted by Adam Kaiser. Galena takes over, 5 minutes and 25 seconds away from their third state championship.
Well, this is just John Winkie trying to make a play that isn't there. Kaiser has just had an outstanding game. If we could name a defensive player, he might be player of the game. He might be it. He has had the toughest assignment all day. You see him one-on-one all day with Travis Surma, the best receiver, and he's just made play after play, Jim.
All right, so Galena takes over at its 15-yard line, and all they want to do right now is pick up a couple of first downs here and run this clock out. Hold on to the football.
Something they've done all day today. One turnover, and that was an interception. As far as running the football, they've been able to hang on to it.
Here's a handoff, this time to Hillard again. Matt Hillard with the carry. He has been the workhorse here in the second half. Decker did most of the carrying of the ball in the first half, but it's been Hillard, and Hillard has been big.
Yeah, Hillard only came into this football game, as you've mentioned a couple times, with only 61 attempts running the football, right around 500 yards. He's had an entire season in this game, it seems like. Every time we look up, Matt Hillard is running the football.
10 carries, 68 yards for Hillard in the second half of this game. Second and six after the four-yard run. And why not use Hillard again? He gets to the 20. Not much on that carry for the senior. And let's see if Coach Ed Freed will test the airwaves once again.
Well, I can imagine we're going to see some kind of boot action or rollout action from Gavin Kaiser. Just get him out on the sideline. Your senior quarterback should stay in bounds. Just use his speed on the corners. You pick the first down, up the first down, that's great. If you don't, punt the football, play defense again.
So Galena taking its time in the huddle. There's only 5 seconds on the play clock. They're going to have to hurry here to avoid a delay of game. And they're going to spend a timeout instead. The play clock was at zero, but Galena got a timeout to avoid the penalty. It stays third and six with 3:59 left to go.
That's right. That timeout was called from the sideline, and you can do that here in high school football. Ed Free didn't like what he saw, made the timeout call, and see what they come up with here, third and long.
Well, Gavin Kaiser has run this Galena offense with near perfection today. Outside of the interception, remember, Galena had a nice drive going the first time they had the football back in the first half. Kaiser threw a pick. Since then, he's been phenomenal. 10 of 15 passing for Kaiser for 145. He's outpassed John Winkie.
Right. Well, that's what you expect out of your senior quarterback. You like to see that.
The Chevy drive of the game. It's brought to us by Chevrolet. See what's new at ChevyDriveChicago.com. And how about Gavin Kaiser changing the momentum? Tuscola just scores. And then Gavin Kaiser on the ensuing kickoff, 93 yards for a touchdown. Not only the longest kickoff return in 1A state championship game history, the longest kickoff return for a touchdown in any state championship game, 1A through 8A.
It's an amazing individual play, and it really changed the whole complexion of this football game.
So now, out of the timeout, Galena, third and six. Kaiser from the shotgun. Quarterback draw to the outside. Kaiser does it again. First down and more as he's out across the 35 before he's finally brought down.
Folks, that might have been the best individual play you've seen all day right there. There's no way this play should have been open. Gavin Kaiser was looking to go inside and just broke it outside. Used his tremendous athletic ability and skill and speed and picked up the first down. Another player down for the Tuscola Warriors.
And that's Jordan Nurr, their fine sophomore linebacker. Who's slow to get up. This has been a hard-hitting game. Galena, very physical team, and you've got Tuscola, you know, some players being asked to do some things that they haven't had to do all season long as a result of the suspensions and the changes that they had to make in their lineup, and Galena taking it to them.
That's a really good point. We haven't mentioned that. You've got these extra players going both ways. They have to be getting tired.
Yeah.
I know it's 14 weeks into the season. They've played a lot of football, but when you're out there and not getting a break, boy, they have to be tired. And, you know, it's admirable what the guys have done and picked up the slack. But, boy, you got to get a lot of credit to Galena and their fine senior group that they have as well.
Kaiser on first down. Clock running here in the fourth quarter. Handoff Hiller trying to bounce it to the outside, and he's going to be wrestled down after a minimal gain there. The clock will continue to roll here. Let's see if Stan Wenke and the Tuscola coaching staff will even use any of their two timeouts that they have left here on defense. 28-7 Galena. Tuscola scored first. We saw the Chevy drive of the game, the Kaiser kickoff return for a touchdown. Since that time, it has been all Galena.
It is. You see a lot of happy Galena fans right there. A lot of blue, a lot of white in the crowd. And they have a lot to be happy for and a lot to cheer for.
Second and nine. Why not to run Hillard again? It's been a pretty effective play call here in the second half. Picks up a couple. Third down, but most importantly, the clock continues to run as Galena is going to inch up over 28 minutes of time of possession in this game. So it'll be third and eight here. Galena won the state championship in 1997. Runner-up in 1999 in the Snow Bowl in 2003 against Leroy, captured a state championship in double overtime, and now back here in 2007 trying to do it again. Delayed handoff, Hiller to the outside, and he dives forward, and he'll be close to the first down. Needed to get to the 41, and he's near the 41.
Boy, that was all because of Vincent Newton, the fine offensive guard for Galena right there. 5'11", 221, a senior. One of those starting senior captains, Vincent Newton's had an outstanding game. And I tell you, that's where we got to give a lot of credit to that offensive line. And I think Ed Freed would be the first one to say that.
I misspoke about the yard line. They needed the 46, and they're just a little bit short. So it's fourth down and less than a yard here. And the play clock ticking down. It's at five right now. And then Galena will take a timeout here and decide what they want to do on fourth down. This could be one of those times where you think, you know, fourth down here, we convert, game over.
Absolutely. I think you have to go for it here.
You don't want to risk a punt and all the things that could happen with a bad punt. I think you go for it here and take your chances. Even if you don't get it, your defense has been dominant all the playoffs long.
We've seen a couple high snaps on both sides for the punt team. Why not just fourth and inches, go for it? If you give up the ball at midfield, you give up the ball. But I got a feeling Ed Freed and his coaching staff will go for it.
Momentum shifting plays in the first half. The kickoff return for a touchdown from Kaiser after Tuscola had scored. And then the fourth down fake punt by Gavin Kaiser that led to Galena's second touchdown to make it 14-7 at halftime. I mean, those two plays, and if those two plays don't happen,
we have a football game, right?
Who knows how the complexion of this game changes?
You're right. And I tell you, I'm very impressed with the game plan that they've come out with. It's been incredible, and they are going to go for it here on fourth and short. You see a good look of Ed Freed right there. A lot of happy Galena football players.
So Kaiser will duck in here. Very tight formation. And he tries a quarterback sneak and breaks away.
Gone.
Kaiser might go. Are you kidding me? He's going to make it into the end zone. A 54-yard touchdown run. It's almost as if he faked the quarterback sneak, bounced it to the outside, and then nobody was home. And Kaiser takes it to the house to put an exclamation point on Galena's state championship victory.
Did you see what Kaiser did right there? He just kind of threw his arms up like, hey, that's what they gave me. I had to take off. There wasn't anything to do in the middle. Tuscola had eight guys in the box. You couldn't do that. Kaiser just makes an unbelievable play.
And that caps off a seven-play, 84-yard touchdown drive for Galena. And Polito with another conversion kick trying to make it 35-7. Would stunning be a way to describe what's happened here?
I'm blown away at this right now. You're seeing a lot of substitutions going on right now. Both coaches trying to get players in on the playing field.
35 unanswered points for the Galena Pirates. There's a hug for head coach Ed Freed as we're going to take a look at this play once again.
Watch your quarterback, Gavin Kaiser. There's nowhere to go. There's five guys right there. He just says, you know what, I see a seam over here to the right. I'm going to use my speed. Picks up one nice block down the field. And once he gets past you, there isn't anybody on this football field that's going to catch him. He's almost amazed himself when he got behind the defensive backs. Huge play for Galena.
Gavin Kaiser showing that speed that's helped him on those 400 and 800-meter relay teams that earned state medals for the Pirates last spring. Some very happy Pirates on the sidelines, and I don't think there's any doubt that most people would have regarded Galena as an underdog in this game, but it's really hard to put a program like Galena's in an underdog status.
Right.
And they've responded, and they've come out here and had a great game plan. It's one thing to have a game plan, Steve. It's another thing to execute it to near perfection.
Oh, no doubt.
And that is what
it.
Galena has done.
Well, we're seeing an entire new kicking unit come in here for Galena as Coach Ed Freed tries to get as many players in this last minute and five that he can onto the field. And what a thrill for some of these young guys to get on Memorial Field.
Here's the kickoff, a short one, taking it about the 25-yard line. And that was Clayton Meyer on the return for the Warriors. And on the other side of things for Tuscola, I mean, this has been a tough week. You know, off the field distractions taking away a little bit. And they won last year, wanted to make history and win back-to-back state titles. It just wasn't meant to be. They ran into a better team today.
Well, I admire how Stan Winkie handled it, too. You know, he had to talk about it. He did all the way up till Monday, and then he told everybody, we're done talking about it. We're moving on. We have a football game played on Friday. We got to. We're done.
Yep.
So I'm not going to talk about it anymore. He's handled it extremely well.
Now, Gavin Kaiser for Galena just making play after play after play. And you know, going up against another All-State quarterback in John Wenke, and it was Gavin Kaiser who turned in the All-State performance here in this game today as Wenke completes another pass. John Wenke has had a great year, a great career for Tuscola, and he's going to go on and play college football for Michigan next year. But it's Gavin Kaiser's day today as he goes to the sidelines, hands in the air, gets the hug
huge
from Ed
hand.
Freed. Oh, man, doesn't that... That just makes you feel so good. You know, I love small school football for the reasons
this
that we're
reason.
Looking at right there. And it's just so special. It's a family thing. It's a school thing. But most importantly, small school football is a community thing.
It's a community thing. No doubt about
it. The entire community gets fired up in it. And it's just really, really fun to see. Here's a drop pass.
Well,
it's been a problem for Tuscola the entire game.
A new quarterback you're going to see is Judd Winkie there, Stan's youngest son, who's a freshman, number 19. He'll probably be the heir apparent to John Winkie. Big, strong kid, great arm, and I think Coach Stan says he's more talented than John is as freshman
as
right
a freshman.
Now.
Yep. Comparing them as freshmen, Judd's better than John.
He's got a lot of work to do, and I'm sure he'll put it in. He's very well coached in a very good program.
There's a handoff for Tuscola. Austin Shelmadine with the carry. First down carry, and he goes out of bounds with 5 seconds to go.
You know, one thing I wanted to say in honor of Coach Stan Winkie, you know, he could have put up some ridiculous numbers for John Winkie this year. John passed for 2,700 yards. It could have been 4,000. But that's the kind of guy he is. It's the kind of program he runs. John had a tremendous season. He's probably going to end up being a high school All-State or All-American and all that. But he could have put up ridiculous numbers. And I think Coach Stan Winkie handled him extremely well. It's got to be tough to coach your son.
This, no doubt about it. This should be the final play of the game. Judd Winkie passes off the mark and incomplete, and that's the ball game. Galena has won its third state championship since 1997. 35-7 is your final score, and some happy Pirate fans across the way. And the team celebrating at about the 40-yard line on the field.
Yeah, you see that. Great coaching staff that Ed Freed has put together. And man, how happy are you for them? You know how many hours of film they've watched, how much practice they've been to, the off-season conditioning. You just have to be thrilled for those guys, Jim.
In the playoffs, well, looking at the assistant coaches, Mike Highland, who's also the athletic director for Galena, Dave Eaton, Pat Beadle, Tim Stevenson, Dan Gunning. And you look at the happy Galena Pirates, and out of the Upstate Illini Conference, another you know, state champion. Galena's won three. You also had Freeport Aquin a couple of years ago out of that conference.
That's right.
You know, winning here in Class 1A. So it's a regular thing for that northwestern part of the state, and it's hard to argue with this statement. If you wanted to find the center for the power of 1A football in the state of Illinois, it would be in the great Northwest.
You have to look north. You're no doubt about that. And this is the great part of high school football right here, the midfield handshake. I love seeing this. It's tough for the Tuscola Warriors to come out and do this, but this is all a part of sportsmanship and what the IHSA promotes. I love seeing this, and you're just very happy for Galena. And hey, let's don't forget, Tuscola's had an incredible season. They'll end their season 12-2, and a phenomenal run they've had the last couple years, Jim.
Yeah, winning the state title last year, and you know, getting back into the state championship game this year, and played a much tougher schedule this year. Tuscola did, playing in a new conference. They were in the Little Oka Conference prior to this year, in the bigger side of the Oka Valley Conference this year, playing against teams like Tolono Unity.
Oh, sure.
And Decatur St. Teresa. And Mowikwa Central A&M, teams that are much larger than Tuscola, and Tuscola stepped it up in terms of competition this year and answered the challenge all the way to the state championship game, only losing to Moroa Forsyth back in week 7. But, you know, Galena wins the state championship on the strength of a dominating, suffocating defense. Five postseason games, and their first team defense allowed one touchdown.
Absolutely. And keys to our game, limit big plays. They did exactly that. They gave up one. And I think Coach Ed Freed would have said, hey, yeah, I'll let them have one. So it was just an incredible overall team effort.
Let's go down to the field for Sarah Kustak and our player of the game.
Guys, Country Insurance player of the game, Gavin Kaiser. Incredible game. But first of all, a couple tricks up your sleeve there on that last touchdown?
No. I mean, Tuscola, they really pounded up the middle, and I really, for the team, I wanted to get the first down and get the clock rolling, but just so happened it went all the way. So I just, this whole team, all year, we've had heart. We believed in ourselves all year. We came in as the underdog, and we enjoyed that. I mean, that gave us extra motivation, and I mean, just unbelievable feeling. The offensive line, they had so much heart tonight. Oh, today, oh man. It's unbelievable.
Got it done on offense, but talk to me a little bit about what your defense did in shutting down this Tuscola team.
That's just our aggressiveness all year. We don't back down on anybody. We're really excited to face such a great team as Tuscola. Great quarterback. We're really excited for the challenge, and our coaches pumped us up the whole time. And I mean, man, what a ride.
Gavin, your kickoff return, the longest kickoff return in Class 1A history. What was going through your mind during that run?
That was a great block. That was just, I saw the hole, and it was just a great blocking, and it was just unbelievable.
Gavin, I'm going to let you go enjoy with your team. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Take
Thank
care.
You.
Guys.
I like one thing that that Gavin said. We were the underdog, and
right.
We kind of, I don't know if they liked being the underdog, but they responded to being the underdog.
It worked well. There's no doubt about it. And did you notice how he deflected all the praise? You know, he kept giving credit to his offensive line, the good blocking, and that did happen. But that Gavin Kaiser is one whale of a football player.
Final numbers for Gavin Kaiser, 10 of 15 passing for 145. He actually outpassed John Wenke in this game. Kaiser with 145 yards passing and Wenke with 139. Also a touchdown pass for Kaiser. And, you know, in the second half, running the football, Ed Freed said, we're going to give it to Matt Hillard a lot. And he responded, 15 carries and 81 yards for Matt Hillard after halftime.
In the second half, absolutely. It was just an incredible effort. It was a team effort. They, you know, they were not one-dimensional. They had three or four players make huge plays. They had their key players make big players. Their cream of the crop rose. You know, Gavin Kaiser, their all-stater, just took the football game over. And what a huge win for the Galena Pirates.
We talked about time of possession and how important that was to Galena. 48 minutes in a high school football game, and Galena had the football for 30 minutes and 11 seconds in this game here today. 9 of 16 for Galena on third down and fourth down combined, and Tuscola was 3 for 15 on third and fourth down combined. We'll be back here to Memorial Stadium in Champaign for more of Galena's state championship celebration after this timeout.
Third state title in 10 years for the Galena Pirates. You can put it in the book. 35-7 over Tuscola. They are the 1A state champions. We welcome you back to Memorial Stadium. Dave Bernhard, along with Jason Kirby, the head coach at Sherrard High School, and Scott Hamilton, head coach at Unity High School. And, you know, we talked about it at the half, what a great first half Galena played. But, boy, you talk about a rock-solid 48-minute performance. That's what Galena put on the board today.
I'd say they must have played their game plan about as well as they could have. Keep big plays from coming and run the football.
Yeah, you know, my hat's off to them. What a great game. What a dominating performance on both sides of the football. Their linebackers played well. They controlled the line of scrimmage, really shut down the run. Needless to say, they had somebody behind the center there that did okay today as well, too.
Gavin Kaiser, we'll talk about the stats with that young man in a second, but you talk about one player that dominated the performance top to bottom. Gavin Kaiser, I mean, he truly did it all. We'll get the exact numbers later, but big games, big players step up, and the biggest one did.
Punting, defense, offense running the ball, very efficient throwing it. You can't ask for anything more out of one player.
No, my hat's off to him. Great young man and a great player, and just a tremendous job.
You know, you take a look at this Galena team as they receive their state championship medals right now. They did come in the underdog. You know, and you say, how does a team that came into this game 13-0 be an underdog, but it was a domination of Tuscola throughout the year? And yes, much has been made through this past week about the suspensions of Tuscola, but make sure the folks from Galena, and I truly hope they and their fans never think about that as any type of an excuse. They came out here, they did play the game of their lives, and they earned every single accolade that they got.
Most certainly, and you know, that they deserve everything they get. You know, my hat's off to the kids for Tuscola who came out and played their hearts out, left it all on the field for their school and their community. And you know, what a good game, what a good way to kick off a fun day of football. And you know, right now Galena's three times in 10 years and doing well.
Indeed, you know, that's the thing. We were looking for possible back-to-back championships, and instead we have a mini dynasty, if you will. But, you know, Jason, you and I were talking a lot, especially during the second half, about where games, football games, I don't care what class, what level of football you're playing, are won, and that's on the line, and the outstanding line play today for the Pirates.
Yeah, and you see a couple of their linemen holding up the trophy right now. That's where this football game was won, in my mind. On the offensive and defensive lines, they were incredibly physical and controlled that aspect of the game dramatically.
Yeah, did a really good job shutting down. You know, we talked about this at halftime a little bit, but did a great job of shutting down Tuscola's run game. And you know, Tuscola came out in the third quarter, was able to get a couple runs to get things going, and then had a second or third down and try to draw a play, an inside run play, and linebacker from Galena came through, made a big play, and kind of took him out of that drive and moved on. On a side note to the game, I think up here from all of us, our thoughts and prayers go out to Zach Martin, the young man from Tuscola who was taken off today, and I hope that everything works out well for him and his family.
Indeed. Obviously, you know, you always get that funny feeling in your stomach when you see a young man carted off on an ambulance. So good luck to them and all the folks from Tuscola. Let's go downstairs and check in with Sarah Kustak. We've got a very happy coach. Sarah?
Thanks, Dave. Actually down here with Tuscola's coach, Winky. Coach, final thoughts on this performance today?
Well, I'm just proud of the kids. I mean, they knew they were shorthanded, but they gave the effort, and that's the most important thing, and that's what we've been trying to get through to them for the 18 years I've been there, there is nothing bigger than the game, and they found out on a big day. And unfortunately, some of the kids that were here had to pay the price, but they'll be better because of it too, I think.
Sounds good, Coach. Congratulations on the second place finish. Dave, back to you guys.
Thank you very much, Sarah. And of course, when you take a look at a coach that goes and players that go first place, second place, and back-to-back years, no matter what circumstances surround that, I mean, that's a great accomplishment. I wouldn't mind having two medals hanging in my closet.
What a run. What a run. You know, Winky and company have had a heck of a run for a few years now. These last 3 years being in the semifinals, state finals. I think those kids have nothing but great memories.
Yeah, and, you know, if little brother has anything to say, the run's not going to end now. And, you know, a lot of kids got a lot of playing time and experience out there, and I don't know that their run's done. So I would look for Tuscola and Coach Winky just to reload and be back ready to go again next fall.
You know, another thing that stood out for me with Galena here today, and it probably started in one of the opening drives, it seemed as if they played with an extreme amount of confidence.
Well, I think as the game plan went on, and they had success, that just builds on itself.
Yeah, the thing I noticed was in a lot of critical plays, it was play action fake, rollouts, getting him outside the pocket, trying able to make a play. And, you know, it almost appeared as though he was a little scared to make the last play and score the last touchdown. But what a performance.
Speaking of touchdowns, what do you say we take a look at the Sports Authority scoring recap? Sports Authority, dedicated to the dedicated. There you see the 14-7 halftime score. Kaiser, a couple of touchdowns, kickoff return, the longest in Class 1A history. Third quarter, Kaiser added a touchdown run. And then, of course, it was Matt Hillard along with Kaiser finishing it off 35-7 on that 54-yard touchdown run. So congratulations to the Galena Pirates. They are your 1A state champions, and they take a perfect record back home to Northwest Illinois. We'll take a break. We come back. There's a lot more going on. In fact, a Class 2A game coming up.
Welcome back to Memorial Stadium here in Champaign, Illinois, as we've got the IHSA football state finals going. We just finished up with the Class 1A game, and I am here with the state champion winner of the Galena Pirates, Coach Ed Freed. Coach, first of all, talk to me what it feels like right now to be a state champion.
Oh, it's a great feeling. It's just unbelievable. I'm just so proud of our guys and our coaching staff. We worked so hard to get to this point, and to be able to beat, you know, Tuscola is a great ball club and a great opponent, and the way we came out today and played, I'm just so proud of them.
There's been a lot of talk about the points put up on the board, about the defensive effort of stopping Tuscola, but I want to hear about your thoughts on the offensive line, because those guys just don't get enough credit.
They don't. Our backs, our skill guys do a tremendous job, but today our offensive line also stepped up huge, and they really have the last half of the season. And we, you know, to keep that type of offense off the field is very important. We're able to run the ball. That's the difference in the game. So offensive line did super today.
What are your thoughts on some of those critical plays that you called a couple trick plays, fake punt, fake quarterback sneak? What were you thinking there?
Well, you know, we knew in order to win the game, we had to be the aggressor as the offense and, you know, try to keep the ball away. And, you know, we rolled the dice a few times. Fortunately, they worked out.
And, Coach, final thoughts. You've got this team here, state champions. You're going to go back in the locker room. What are you telling these kids?
Well, I'm just going to tell them I'm so proud of them. I mean, we got a great group of guys, and that makes it so fun to coach. And just to see their excitement as a coach, that's what it's all about. And these guys have worked so hard, great character, and I'm just very proud of them.
Coach, enjoy. Go have fun.
Thank you.
Dave, back up to you guys.
All right, thanks, Sarah. That was the happy coach I was looking for a little while ago, Ed Freed, the head coach of the Galena Pirates. Third state title for the Pirates in the last 10 years. Congratulations to them. And, you know, you take a look at this ballgame. We saw so many big numbers coming into this game in terms of Tuscola, Galena, offense, defense, but here's how they look today. And first of all, Jason, it starts with time of possession, and it's really, you get a time of possession situation like this, you're going to win ball games.
No doubt. On the sheet, 30 minutes, 11 seconds. For Galena with time of possession. That goes back to what we said earlier with the offensive and defensive line plays, making sure that Tuscola can't have long sustained drives and Galena just marching the ball up and down the field, eating the clock up, making sure that quick strike offense can't be on the field and is getting nothing done in the running game as well, Tuscola not having any luck at all there.
Yeah, you know, Tuscola just never could seem to get it going today. You know, Galena was able to hold Schultz to 62 yards, 59 net yards, able to hold Winky under 50% passing, which he's been, 65 to 70% his entire career, and 139, about 80 yards on the ground. Quite a dominating performance.
Talk about dominating. Gavin Kaiser, we have six or seven individual statistical categories here. Gavin Kaiser is in every single one. Nine rushes, 93 yards. Passing, 10 of 15, 145 yards and a touchdown. He's there for punting and kick returns. He's also made it for, tackles. He didn't get to return a punt today. Too bad for Gavin. But, I mean, that's a tremendous all-state type performance.
He did get the fake punt, though.
Yeah,
you are right. Yeah, he was thinking about it. But, I mean, great players again, and his numbers bear it out.
No doubt. The 66% passing was huge. How about him on the counteraction, bootlegs, and things of that nature, where they're getting first downs and outrunning the one person that's got contained over and over again. Success because of that player having incredible ability.
I think that, you always hear the old talk about speed and size, and, you know, it's 6'3", 180, 85 pounds and can run like he did. It makes you a tremendous athlete, and, in a game like this, athletes take over, and he did today.
You know, you mentioned the time of possession and keeping the ball out of the hands of Tuscola. 5 of 12 third downs, 4 of 4 in fourth downs. That's money.
Yeah, No doubt about it. When you can continue to do that, things are going to work in your favor. No turnovers. The turnover on the opening drive.
Right.
Outside of that, there weren't turnovers through the course of the game for Galena. The fake punt was huge. Gutsy call at that time, at that point in the game when it was still a very tight game. So many things went their way.
It's good to have gutsy calls when you got a 6'3", 190-pounder that can run like that. He makes you look awfully good.
Makes you look pretty smart.
Yep. So what a day for him.
Indeed. What a day for the Galena Pirates. You can package this one up in a nice little DVD and enjoy it for years. You are the Class 1A state champs. Galena, final score 35-7 over Tuscola, and you're looking right now at Memorial Stadium. Warming up our 2A contenders, Dakota, Westville, both 13-0. We'll talk more about that when we come back.